And we welcome you to TNT's All-Star NBA Tip-Off presented by Nokia. Great look at the Pepsi Center here in Denver. The host of All-Star 2005. The game is played on Sunday. There's Dr. J, Julius Erving tonight. It's slam dunking and three-point shooting and skills and legends wherever you look. It should be a feast. And we're on hand to bring it to you live here from Denver, Colorado. Ernie Johnson, Kenny the Jet Smith, Charles Barkley. Now, if Charles is an expert on the Sunday All-Star, you're an expert on Saturday night at the All-Star game, Kenny, because you have been there and know what it's like to have the stage all to yourself with everybody in the place looking at you.
Well, the funny thing about Saturday night is this is the only time that you're, even as a professional athlete and probably even as an amateur athlete, where you're on the court without your teammates. You're by yourself, and you get to show the things that you work on in a gym with no one watching.
Are the jitters the same at all, a game and this kind of a thing? Are they?
This is worse because you always have someone to defer to. When you walk out the tunnel with 12 guys, if you're nervous, you can always look at somebody or somebody come and pat you on the back. But when you walk out by yourself and the stage is set, you got 22,000 people, and they're expecting not the average, not the good, they're expecting the great. That's when it's a little bit nerve-wracking.
Always fun to see what guys have got cooked up for this night, isn't it, Chuck?
Well, you know, realistically, the three-point shoot contest has, to me, surpassed the dunk as far as the level of excitement. I like the little skills thing. That's pretty fun. Gives us a lot of the young guys to see the WNBA players and some of the older guys and some of the young stars. But the three-point shooting contest has become my favorite. The slam dunk, it's just a tough event now because people have expectations are so high.
We'll get everybody's picks on the events just a little bit later. The PlayStation Skills Challenge will feature four players: Earl Boykins, Luke Ridenour, Steve Nash, and the guy that Cheryl Miller talked to a short time ago, Gilbert Arenas.
Thanks a lot, EJ. Joining me is Gilbert Arenas from the Washington Wizards. And first of all, let's talk a little bit about Washington. Has surprised a lot of teams in the first half of the season. What I'm hearing in the East, second half of the season and the playoffs, you don't want to face the Wizards. Is that true?
Yeah, I mean, we're playing with a lot of confidence. We believe in ourselves and, you know, we're not letting any outside distractions, you know, tear our team apart.
We spoke earlier today about just respect. It's been a long road for you. Talk about your first All-Star selection and what it's meant to you.
Oh, I mean, it means a lot, you know. I'm happy. I can't believe I'm here, but, you know, I'm enjoying it, and, you know, I'm just happy to be here. I can't believe it, though.
Well, let's talk about the skills challenge that you'll be participating in later on in the evening. What's the strategy?
Just do it as fast as I can.
Fast may not always be wise, but as fast as you can, and what else?
Make sure I get the passes down. I'm going to make the shot. You know, it's just the passes, a little bounce pass. If I get the bounce pass, I'm good.
You know, spoken like a true shooting guard. EJ, listen to back to you.
All right, thank you, Cheryl.
That's what I was like. He's a point guard. He's talking about that bounce pass is tough, man. A point guard says bounce pass is tough.
They must have not asked Miami and Detroit. They sure ain't afraid to see what's up. They must have been talking about Cleveland.
So, who do you like in that one? Boykins, Luke Ridenour, Steve Nash, Gilbert Arenas.
Well, if you're going to go strictly on speed, it's got to be Earl Boykins.
I go with Boykins just because he's small enough to get jumped through the hoop instead of passing through.
And he's such a nice little man.
Nice little man.
I'm going to just tell you, I got to tell this quick story. Last night I'm walking
David
into
Thompson.
Who doesn't get the credit he deserves.
Redhead. Used to be redhead.
I'm walking in the club last night, and this little kid says, Charles, I can't get in. I turned to my right, and it's Earl Boykins. It was such a cute little story. Hey, man, because people think he's small. He can flat out play, though.
Thank you for sharing that with us. By the way, I'm taking Luke Ridenour.
Oh, you're going with the white guy, huh?
I didn't go with Steve Nash.
Taking Luke, you'll see. By the way, if you got a Nokia 6600, 6620 video phone, you know, you can get more stuff from Kenny and Charles.
Wait,
stream right to your phone.
No,
and he hasn't been traded via the phone yet either. Log on to NokiaUSA.com or NBA.com for more info.
NBA All-Star set. NBA All-Star Weekend continues on Rogers Sportsnet. It's East versus West, and defense is optional. The game's best square off at the annual NBA All-Star Game. Coverage begins tomorrow at 7:30 Eastern, 4:30 Pacific on Rogers Sportsnet.
Well, I had a dream. I stood beneath an orange sky.
The multifunctional element.
Yes, I had a dream. I
from Honda.
Stood beneath an orange sky.
Where will it take you?
Renegade occultist John Constantine has been to hell and back. Warner Brothers and Roger Sportsnet invite you to discover who is John Constantine.
You do this, there's no turning back.
Plug on a sportsnet.ca to find out and enter for your chance to win a state-of-the-art 26-inch widescreen Aquos liquid crystal TV from Shark, PlayStation 2 console, and Constantine video game, plus other cool prizes. In theaters February 18th, the Constantine Contest.
Go to hell.
Only at sportsnet.ca.
Hey, Don, can we get your...
Just a minute, darling, just a minute.
This Quiznos real deal menu? It's great. $3.99 every day.
Not that, it's the taste.
$3.99.
It's the taste.
$3.99.
Taste.
$3.99.
You want to go?
Grapes? I'm a finesse player now.
Oh, well, those hands, you're not.
What did you say?
It was him, Todd.
Introducing the Quiznos Meatball Sandwich, one of six oven toasted real deal sandwiches.
$3.99 every day.
Quiznos. Toasty. Nobody stands behind their cars like Mitsubishi. Because every new Mitsubishi now comes with a 10-year powertrain limited warranty, 5-year new vehicle limited warranty, and 5-year roadside assistance. Mitsubishi, the best back cars in the world. He came back, came on my chance.
Man, I kind of wonder this guy.
I don't know how you sit next to him. I'm glad you're the bumper between the two of us. He's a little frisky tonight. And now that it's safe to come back on camera, we welcome you back to...
Something you've heard a lot. No, no Charles, no.
Exactly.
You heard that a lot this weekend.
So I'm going to name three guys who have had the platform on All-Star Saturday night. D. Brown, Kenny Skywalker, Spud Webb. And the question you might be asking, where are they now? Would you ask me that?
I know where one of
where
them is.
Where are they now?
I know where
well,
are they now?
I'm trying. Here's Jim Huber.
I wasn't through, Ernie.
Two of you who elevated their careers into a far different stratosphere, Dr. J, Michael Jordan, Kobe Bryant, this is merely an asterisk on their resume. But to the majority, no matter the length and quality of their NBA lives, they see this as their one glorious defining moment.
And as they drift into the relative obscurity of retirement, this then begins to serve as a shining beacon, drawing the curious.
I made that up right on the spot. I never did that dunk ever before that time, never practiced it.
It was Charlotte, 1991, and D. Brown was a rookie with the Boston Celtics.
Nobody knew who I was. I mean, people knew I played for the Celtics and, you know, I was a player in the NBA, but they didn't think I was in there. The dunk contest, just because Celtic players are not in the dunk contest. Went out, pumped the shoes up, and you know, the crowd got excited.
Pumping his shoes up.
We started running. I said, well, what am I gonna do? When I went up, it went from here and it just kept going. My arm just kept going. Didn't see the basket. I knew, judging where I took off from, how far I had to go, and that's just instinct of dunking. You know, seeing those guys just getting so excited for little old me, you know, 21-year-old rookie out of Jacksonville, Florida, and see a Celtic win it was just like the best feeling in the world.
D. Brown continues to be remembered for that one blinding moment 14 years ago.
I still get recognized, and it is. Initially, it's because of the slam dunk contest.
Ask Kenny Walker about that. The man who became known forever as Skywalker was in his third year with the Knicks when he walked into that spotlight in the 1989 contest in Houston. When he finally landed, his life had changed forever.
Without a doubt, my biggest moment as an NBA player was winning the 1989 slam dunk contest. What I did was took a Dominique Wilkins dunk, which is a 360, but I added a double pump in there where I was able to bring it down and almost tap the ball on my heel while turning around to dunk the ball. That, I thought, was probably my best dunk.
He trades on his place in University of Kentucky history with various radio shows in Lexington, always, however, with the tag of slam dunk champion for authenticity.
I'm Kenny Rice.
And I'm Kenny Skywalker.
19 years ago, right here at Reunion Arena in Dallas, 5'7" Spud Webb first took flight, and the basketball world hasn't stopped talking since. Oddly enough, not one of Spud Webb's Atlanta teammates knew he could even get up high enough to dunk. Not even his good friend Dominique Wilkins.
You see how I've been holding out on him.
From the Atlanta Hawks, standing 5'7", Spud Webb.
Only the first one that I had in mind what I was going to do. After that, it was like whenever he gave me the ball, that's when I thought of what dunk to do.
Unlike the others, who take great solace in their shining moment, it took Spud Webb a long time to accept the fact that this would be his unlikely legacy.
Well, it didn't mean anything back then because I didn't know how big an influence it would take. And now, that's how people notice you from winning a dunk contest. And, I mean, even kids that I think weren't even born when I had the dunk contest know. And that's when you know that it was pretty special.
And so they move on, feet firmly on the ground these days. But for the rest of their lives, they will be remembered for their astonishing feats of flight.
Thank you very much, Jim Huber. Now,
you know what?
Yeah, what?
Spud Webb winning the slam dunk contest is one of the great sports accomplishments ever.
I agree with you. I remember I wasn't there. I remember working as a local sports guy and reading that it had happened and it was going to be on that night on TBS and watching it later. It was an.
But basically.
Did he beat you?
No, I wasn't in that year. I wasn't even in the NBA that year. I was still a youngster. You were about your 15th year in the league by that time. But no, he's the guy who started the lob. Everyone else when used to sit on the floor. But then Spud threw it in the air and it changed everything now. You'll see it tonight in the dunk contest. People throwing it in the air.
Exactly, yeah, but a 5'7"
right.
Guy dunking, some of those dunks were incredible.
That was incredible.
Yeah.
Hey, as far as picks go for tonight, Magic, of course, is in the Shooting Stars. Relaying his picks, he likes Ray Allen to win the Foot Locker three-point shootout. He likes Josh Smith, the teenager
cheated.
From the Hawks,
he must have saw my list.
To win the Sprite Rising Stars slam dunk. Kenny's.
Oh, my God. We all picked the same people.
Oh, no, I'm switching
tell me that.
I'm going to switch.
Okay, let's go to Charles first.
We all got the same
Mr.
thing.
No, we don't all have the same thing.
Yeah. Oh, well, you missed?
No, I didn't miss. Is Josh Smith. And look at that old picture. And Kyle Korver,
who picked Kyle Korver last year.
And he made the finals. He was 7 out of 10 last night in the Got Milk Rookie Challenge.
I mean, he's going to be.
Hey, but you know what? Hey,
Ray Allen's in the zone right now.
But Chuck, such a great professional. You talked about professional players and how Ernie never messes up and never gets upset at messing up.
I've never said that.
He never gets upset. But today. All-Star Weekend on the biggest stage, it was a little bit different. Check this out.
What happened?
Just check this out.
First of all, it's
what is
music.
Dog my cat?
What the hell is dog my cat?
It means whatever you want it to mean. It's just fun to say. Well, dog my cat. It can mean, well, I'm amazed about that, or it can mean, well, dog my cat.
No, Ernie.
How can you dog a cat? And it's not offensive to anybody.
Except for the dog and the cat.
It's stupid to everybody.
You're going to use it in no time, Charles. Hey, there's Buck. Buck's ready to go.
I predict an upset in this.
I'm taking the Denver team in there. Okay,
I'm taking Phoenix.
I'm taking my Phoenix Suns team also.
Okay, I'll take Denver there. That'll be my first win of the year.
The great Alex English.
Alex been coaching. He ain't been shooting.
We shall return.
It's all about the money. You could win up to $250,000 in the Ericsson Ultimate Nassau Golf Tournament presented by Rogers Wireless. Take your game to the next level and be part of the action on Rogers Sportsnet, sponsored in part by Islands of the Bahamas. Register at ultimatenassau.com and for details.
It's Canada's Lobster Fest, the one time of year when butter has a higher calling. Lobster Fest is back, only at Red Lobster.
Well, I had a dream. I stood beneath an orange sky.
The multifunctional element.
Yes, I had a dream. I
from Honda.
Stood beneath an orange sky.
Where will it take you?
Hey! Who shipped the 200 boxes to our client in Boston? Was it you, Lewis?
I shipped them with FedEx.
You're a heck of a man doing a heck of a job, Lewis.
Trust the company with proven reliability. Relax, it's FedEx.
Yeah.
Hey, honey, the directions you gave me are terrible.
Split right, zoom,
split
76X.
Right. 76!
Okay, here's what you need to do. Take 72. There's that big wall on your right.
All right, let's go!
Around the jug handle, you'll be there.
That's jug handle!
Okay, love you.
It's Canada's Lobster Fest, the one time of year when butter has a higher calling. Lobster Fest is back, only at Red Lobster.
Saturday night, there's Chuck's buddy Dan Marley getting loose. Good.
That's his number. Can you show one of my idols out there, Adrian Dantley?
It's Ronald. There's Ronald Dupree. One of your idols? Luke Walton?
If his dad named Marcus Dupree, he is. You got to show Agent Dantley.
Lisa Leslie?
Yes, indeed. Back here at our perch at
Charles
the
Barkley.
Oh, I'm an idol? Oh,
Pepsi
thanks, man.
Center. By
thanks.
The way.
I was your idol growing up?
No, actually, you are one of my favorite players, actually.
I know you're old cut. The old country family didn't have cable.
There you go.
That's
you
my
go.
Man.
Your
one
request.
Of my eyes. Him and John Drew, two guys who made it possible for me to play in the NBA.
Meantime, you guys were fairly unanimous in selecting Ray Allen as the three-point champion tonight. And a little while ago, Cheryl Miller.
He got
Miller,
no chance, Dan. We jinxed him.
Cheryl Miller with Ray Allen.
Thanks a lot, EJ. Joining me is the ever-smiling Ray Allen. And Ray, this is your fifth All-Star selection. Does it ever get old? Is it still exciting?
Always. You know, that first time to now, you get that phone call and they say you made the All-Star team. You jump up and down, your family jumps down. It's a great time to enjoy your life.
Well, what do you say to Seattle, Rashard Lewis? He's experiencing his first All-Star appearance.
Everything, you know, and he's such a great guy because everything that, you know, I've talked about this weekend, he just sits back and listens, and, you know, he's a great guy, and definitely it's great for me to experience this with him.
Now, at your practice this morning, I should say, you hit a three-point shot. You were warming up for the three-point competition, which you won in 2001, but your teammates saying it was rigged.
I don't know how you can rig a half-court shot. You know, it's not like I expected to make it, but at the same time, it went in, and guys were looking at me weird because none of them made it. None of them came close, and it went in, and, hey, I'm a shooter. That's what I do.
Hey, it's all about the range. Just send it back to you, EJ.
All right, thank you, Cheryl and Ray. And we have really been working Cheryl hard because obviously you saw her a short time ago here, and then she was over at the convention center this morning as the All-Stars were practicing, and there she caught up with one of the dunkers tonight, Amari Stoudemire.
Oh, it's always special when you got the whole Star 5 here to enjoy All-Star weekend, and plus I'm in two events. It's my first time being in an All-Star game, so I'm really out just trying to enjoy myself.
Now, tonight you're in the slam dunk competition, and I spoke to Sean, your teammate. He says you have something very special planned. Can you give us a little insight?
I don't want to spill the beans quite yet, but, you know, I got something planned, though.
You know, let's talk about, you said you have some other teammates involved in this weekend. Let's talk about Quentin Richardson and Joe Johnson. Of course, Q in three-point shootout puts up a lot of shots, but Joe has a better percentage. Who do you like heading into that competition?
It's going to be tough to choose between the two because both of them got qualities of pretty much getting hot. So that's pretty much what it comes down to. Whoever gets hot first, you know, probably going to win.
How about Steve Nash in the skills competition?
Oh, I think Steve got that hands down. He got great skills.
Hey, thanks a lot for your time.
having great skills is a prerequisite for being good in these skills competition.
That would help.
Meantime, if there's anybody who can speak to both events, the three-point and the dunk, having participated in both, and the strategy involved, it would be Kenny the Jet Smith.
Well, I think first in a dunk contest is you have to come out and show the judges something. Thank you, Ernie. You have to show them something from the start. You can't wait and say, I'm going to wait for my third dunk. You got to get the crowd behind you. You got to get the judges behind you in the dunk contest. The three-point contest is a pacing because it is a little bit different. You have to learn to pace yourself on each shot, and that's what's big. And I was fortunate one year to do both in the same year.
That is.
Person to do that.
Did you eat? Did you win either one of them?
Did I eat?
No.
You
no.
See where your mind is? You see, I'm not going to let you slip on
wait,
that.
Yeah,
I ate earlier
win,
today. Did you eat
no.
today?
Of course.
Did
I
you
didn't.
Eat? Yeah, just checking. I ate today,
wait,
too.
Wait, did you win either?
I ate both of them.
Wait, it's a flat out. He has nothing to come back.
Yeah.
What,
I ate both
what
of
impresses
them.
The Chuckster about a dunk contest? What impresses the Chuckster in 15 seconds or less?
Creativity. I want to see that. They discriminate against the big guys. That's why I don't think Amari Stoudemire can win it. That's why I went with John Smith.
It's coming your way next year on TNT.
Boy, am
enjoy
I hungry.
It, folks.
Closed captioning is brought to you by Fidelity Investments, investing in best interests for over 50 years.
Battling heartburn? Experience a whole new Tums with a unique dual-layer tablet. Tums Dual Action quickly neutralizes stomach acid, then helps keep heartburn away. New Tums Dual Action. It works fast, and it lasts. It has been awarded the government's highest possible crash test rating, 5 stars, outscoring a long list of America's most popular SUVs. It is the beautifully redesigned, remarkably re-engineered all-wheel drive Subaru Outback. Follow this star to your Subaru dealer today.
Subaru Outback. Full-time all-wheel drive. Maximum 5-star protection.
The moment you've been waiting for is here. That's right. It's the end of late fees at Blockbuster in Canada. Need an extra day or two with your movies and games? Take them. Because now, renting is better than ever.
It's so beautiful.
Thank you.
The end of late fees now in Canada. That's more from Blockbuster.
Right now, buy a specially marked 8-pack of Duracell batteries and get ready to pop the copper top. You could win one of three $10,000 cash prizes, valuable coupons, and free product. It could only take one pop to pop the copper top for $10,000.
Ladies and gentlemen, we ask you to please rise for the singing of the national anthems of the United States and Canada. Here to perform O Canada is multi-talented singer, instrumentalist, and Ontario native, M. Griner.
O Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all our sons command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard.
The Star-Spangled Banner is rising country music star and BNA recording artist, Blaine Larson.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Prepare to be visibly moved, inspired, and astonished. Check out the Sportsnet News Top 7 of 7.
Holy cow!
And savor the most superb plays of the week.
Driving and flipped up a wild reverse! Now that deserves a view! Kidding me!
Thing hit the clouds. Look at the spin on that shot.
Collins to the back of the end zone. Curry! Touchdown!
This is as good a catch as you'll ever see.
The Top 7 of 7, Monday on Sportsnet News.
It has been awarded the government's highest possible crash test rating, 5 stars, outscoring a long list of America's most popular SUVs. It is the beautifully redesigned, remarkably re-engineered all-wheel drive Subaru Outback. Follow this star to your Subaru dealer today.
Subaru Outback, full-time all-wheel drive, maximum 5-star protection.
The moment you've been waiting for is here. That's right, it's the end of late fees at Blockbuster in Canada. Need an extra day or two with your movies and games? Take them. Because now, renting is better than ever.
It's so beautiful.
Thank you.
The end of late fees now in Canada. That's more from Blockbuster.
Well, I had a dream. I stood beneath an orange sky.
The multifunctional element.
Yes, I had a dream. I
from Honda.
Stood beneath an orange sky.
Where will it take you?
The NBA is on Rogers Sportsnet and Raptors NBA TV. Just subscribe to the 5 Sportsnet channels. Sportsnet East, Sportsnet Ontario, Sportsnet West, Sportsnet Pacific, and Sportsnet HD. Plus, Raptors NBA TV.
Oh, boy!
And get over 380 NBA games this season, including 68 in high definition. For more info, call your television service provider.
Bring it home, baby. Bring it home.
Get the most hoops on Rogers Sportsnet and Raptors NBA TV all season long.
I guess.
Saturday night.
All-Star Saturday is all about showtime.
It's like it's Saturday night.
You know you got the dunk contest, the three-point shootout, and of course the contest I know most about, the Skills Challenge.
Watch it!
That's where you can see who really got game. I'm talking about all the tools, baby.
Watch me!
Speed, quickness, balance, cut left, cut right, no-look pass, behind the back, and of course the crossover. Watch out for your ankle is broke. Mommy, come get me. Only a handful of players have all of that working at the same time. The guys have got skills, baby.
Yeah, yeah, you can't hate the skills magic, but the player with the real game is the guy who's cool under pressure when the big shot is on the line.
They're just shooting.
But when it comes to changing a game magic, it's about who can stroke the big three. I'm talking about the three-point guy, the guy you want with the ball when the clock is racing to zero. That's what this is about. Three after three after three. And those are my guys, period.
Excuse me, gentlemen, no disrespect, but let's be honest. All-Star Saturday isn't about what's happening on the court. It's about what's happening above the court. And these are my guys.
It's your pain. You do what you want to do.
It's all about the cat who comes through with the new sickness, the nasty, nasty. This is how legends are made. It's about that dunk.
That perfect flick of the wrist.
Who really has game?
Can you see it?
Ooh, it's awesome.
This is what All-Star Saturday is all about.
You don't want to miss it. It's too much going on. Ooh, it's going to be off the chain up in here.
Man, that was good.
Woo! Live from Denver, Colorado, it's NBA All-Stars Saturday night, presented by America Online. Tonight, the NBA's best compete in the Radio Shack Shooting Stars, the PlayStation Skills Challenge, the Foot Locker 3-Point Shootout, and the Sprite Rising Stars Slam Dunk. Now, let's send it to tonight's public address announcer, Jonathan Wild.
Welcome to Denver for NBA All-Star Saturday Night. Let's start the party with one of the hottest songs in the country. Here with her hit, Since You've Been Gone, is chart-topping RCA recording artist, Kelly Clarkson.
Here's the thing, we started our friends. It was cool, but it was all pretend. Yeah, yeah. Since you've been gone, you dedicated, you took the time. It wasn't long till you called you mine. Yeah, yeah. Since you've been gone, and all you ever hear me say, how I picture me with you. That's all you ever hear me say. But since you've been gone, I can't breathe for the first time. I'm summoning it all, yeah, yeah. Back to you, now I get what I want. Since you've been gone, put me on. I even fell for a stupid love song. Yeah, yeah. Since you've been gone, how come I never hear you say, I just wanna be with you. Well, I guess you never felt that way. But since you've been gone, I can't breathe for the first. Again and again and again and again. But since you've been gone, yeah, since you've been gone, since you've been gone.
Kelly Clarkson! And now, let's meet the competitors in Radio Shack Shooting Stars! Representing Detroit, from the Detroit Pistons, Ronald Dupree! From the Detroit Shock, Swin Cash! And Detroit legend, Adrian Dantley! For Phoenix, from the Phoenix Suns, Sean Marion. From the Phoenix Mercury, Diana Taurasi. And Phoenix legend, Dan Marley. Competing for the home city of Denver, from your Denver Nuggets, Andre Miller. WNBA New York Liberty star guard and University of Colorado at Denver graduate, Becky Hammond. And Denver Nuggets legend, Alex English. And for Los Angeles, winners of the Radio Shack Shooting Stars 2004, from the Lakers, Luke Walton. From the Sparks, six-time WNBA All-Star, Lisa Leslie. And a true Laker legend, one of the 50 greatest players in NBA history, Magic Johnson.
Ladies and gentlemen.
And we're back after this on TNT.
NBA All-Star Weekend on Rogers Sportsnet, brought to you by Hyundai, by McDonald's, and by Molson Canadian.
The Coors Light Brewing Company salutes the buddy.
I have told a ridiculous lie to back up a friend's ridiculous lie.
I have slept outside
because a friend put a sock on the doorknob.
I have never hooked up with a friend's sister
more than once.
I have been a friend
by being with my friends, girlfriends,
friend.
The Coors Light Brewing Company is proud of all the brothers from different mothers and the easy drinking taste of the ice-cold Silver Bullet.
He's a cop. He's not.
He who is without sin cast the first stone.
It slipped.
But when five cheerleaders witness a murder, they're the only team.
Nobody is trying to kill us.
That can protect them.
You girls are cheerleaders, huh? Back in my day, we brought it.
Everybody dance now! Tommy Lee Jones, Man of the House, with Cedric the Entertainer.
Now that's old school.
Opens everywhere Friday.
Is this the help desk? I need help.
What kind of help?
Dinosaurs and robots and outer space and why the sky is blue. Lots of stuff.
Don't you learn that in school?
I don't go to school. It's too far. I live on a farm in China.
I see.
Is there room for me over there?
We're virtual. There's always room.
Yes.
Help desk.
SpeedStick 24/7 gives you proven non-stop protection. With time-release sweat and odor fighters, SpeedStick's always there when you need it the most. For as long as you need it. SpeedStick 24/7. It never quits.
The championship is coming. The NCAA tournament starts March 15th on Rogers Sportsnet.
And we're back in Denver, and a live Spanish feed available via the SAP button on your remote.
Well, here we are, Charles Barkley and Kenny the Jet. And the great shooting Steve Kerr.
Oh my gosh, Steve Kerr, you embarrassed the whole TNT family tonight.
Thanks, I appreciate that, Charles.
I'm not saying it. How did you embarrass him, Steve? Just tell the world.
Let's take a look at the Radio Shack.
You lost to Kenny
stars.
Smith. Oh, okay, sorry.
Six numbered shooting spots will be placed on the floor to designate each shot location. And the team that hits all six shots in the shortest amount of time will be declared the winner. Each team will be given up to 2 minutes to do this, and those are some of the rules involved with the Shooting Stars competition. Each team comprised of NBA players, WNBA players, and NBA legends competing for $75,000, $30,000 going to the winner, $22,500 going to second place, and on down the line. Log on to NBA.com or America Online, keyword NBA.com to vote on which team you think will win the Radio Shack Shooting Stars competition. Those teams are Detroit, Phoenix, Denver, and Los Angeles. A good crowd. We just had Kelly Clarkson, as you saw. Got to get the crowd
you know what,
ready
like,
to go.
I like Kelly Clarkson. She's no Janet Jackson. Let's play ball.
But for completely different reasons, right, Charles?
I like Kelly Clarkson now, but I need Janet Jackson.
Now, Charles, what were you telling that Swank told you about her knee?
She said she tore her ACL, but when you look at her jump, you can tell she's favoring her leg.
Come on, Adrian. Knock this down with regularity.
You know, Adrian Dantley, him and John Drew are my two mentors.
Ronald Dupree shooting a set shot from three.
This is Swank Cash, who is a WNBA All-Star forward with the WNBA 0-3 champion Detroit Shock.
Is there a time limit on this?
2 minutes, Charles.
Oh, 2 seconds. Oh, this is Kenny.
You can see that she's favoring her leg when she jumps and how she comes down. She's a terrific player.
Come on.
How she's been to the Steve Kerr School of Shooting.
Over the weekend, baby.
Oh, man.
Yeah, Adrian Dantley went to the Kenny Smith School this week.
Oh, he got to make this. That was the money ball. Here's another two-point shot. And Dantley with a two-point shot. And Dupree. And they'll keep shooting until they have a chance to pop one in.
I think Adrian's going to be the one who makes it. Adrian Dantley.
Do they call this a skill competition?
No, this is the shooting star.
That's a chance.
Ronald Dupree of the Detroit Pistons. And a guy who...
So you keep shooting
in the NBTL.
You keep shooting threes till you make one?
Yes.
What time are we getting off the air?
Sound like a guy I used to play with, Vernon Maxwell. He used to shoot three, made it.
This is the favorite right here, I think. Phoenix, you got Marion and Marley who could both make threes, and Diana Taurasi is an unbelievable shooter. She's one of those players who makes half quarters, too. She does special things, so I think this is the team to beat.
She was the rookie of the year on the WNBA.
They definitely the youngest team.
I tell you, Dan Marley's uniform, the throwback, is the hottest jersey out there right now. That's hot.
Here is Sean Marion.
And here you go. Diana Taurasi will make this three. I'm telling you.
I'm going with Thunder Dan.
I'm going to go with Sean Marion.
You just want to be different. Well, you are different.
Damn, Marley. Case McCall's it there.
Nobody's going to be 28 seconds.
No, absolutely not.
They won't be 28 seconds if they did it again right now.
28 seconds.
Phoenix has a time of 28 seconds.
Wow.
Magic Johnson and Los Angeles are still to compete. NBA All-Star Saturday night presented by America Online continues on TNT from Denver, Colorado.
The NBA is on Rogers Sportsnet and Raptors NBA TV. Just subscribe to the five Sportsnet channels: Sportsnet East, Sportsnet Ontario, Sportsnet West, Sportsnet Pacific, and Sportsnet HD. Plus, Raptors NBA TV. And get over 380 NBA games this season, including 68 in high definition. For more info, call your television service provider.
Bring it home, baby. Bring it home.
Get the most hoops on Rogers Sportsnet and Raptors NBA TV all season long. No
nobody stands behind their cars like Mitsubishi. Because every new Mitsubishi now comes with a 10-year powertrain limited warranty, 5-year new vehicle limited warranty, and 5-year roadside assistance. Mitsubishi, the best back cars in the world.
The Coors Light Brewing Company salutes the Buddy.
I have told a ridiculous lie to back up a friend's ridiculous lie.
I have slept outside.
Because a friend put a sock on the doorknob.
I have never hooked up with a friend's sister.
More than once.
I have been a friend.
By being with my friends.
Girlfriends.
Friend.
The Coors Light Brewing Company is proud of all the brothers from different mothers and the easy drinking taste of the ice-cold Silver Bullet.
Hey, Don, can we get your...
Just a minute, darling. Just a minute.
This Quiznos Real Deal menu? It's great. $3.99 every day.
Not that. It's the taste.
$3.99.
It's the taste.
$3.99.
Taste.
$3.99.
You want to go?
Grapes? I'm a finesse player now.
Introduce sandwich, one of six, oven toasted.
$3.99.
Quiznos. Toast. Master 3. And Master 3 anticipates so much of what you want and need in a car. It'll make your head remarkably responsive, yet Mazda 3 and Mazda 3 Sport.
Back in Denver, NBA All-Star Saturday night. TNT's exclusive coverage of NBA All-Star Weekend continues tomorrow night with the 54th annual NBA All-Star Game featuring performances by Destiny's Child, Leanne Rimes, and country duo Big and Rich. Coverage at 8 o'clock Eastern Time with TNT NBA All-Star tip-off presented by Nokia exclusively on TNT and the Phoenix Trio. Finishing 6 of 10 in 28 seconds. And so Sean Marion, Diana Taurasi, and Dan Marley are in first. And here comes Denver with Andre Miller, Becky Hammond, and the great Alex English.
Alex shot early.
They're waiting on Andre Miller.
I think they should have put Alex at the 3-point spot.
Right. He's a good player, but he's not a great shooter. Miss a couple more, we're going to need a Snicker bar.
Oh, see, that doesn't even look natural.
He can't shoot long distance.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh, oh, Alex. Alex ain't played in years.
Oh! I tell you what, if Becky don't make one, we're going to be here.
Alex, there it is. Becky's the best shooter out there, without doubt.
No,
not in Alex Addings' day.
She
I'm
going to
tell you now, in his day.
No, Alex
not in his day.
No, but he's never been a long-range shooter, though.
True. Ooh, I want that Magic Johnson throwback right there that he's coming out on the court with.
That is a Magic Johnson throwback.
Oh, that's him. Oh, I was talking about the jersey. Okay.
That is him. Hey, that's not Magic Johnson. That's a Magic Johnson throwback.
So this trio, Lisa Leslie, Luke.
Oh, close that door. Close that door. There you go.
Johnson.
Whoa, close that door. That door is open. The door is open.
Right?
Okay, Magic.
You might need that Snicker bar over there.
Hey, we're going to put a T in front of that.
There you go.
Tragic. Luke's not a 3-point shooter either. You can see he looks uncomfortable with that.
He's the best shooter out of them three, though.
I would say you're right. They've won 2 years in a row, though.
That pressure starts to build, too. You miss 4 or 5 in a row, you start to feel tight out there.
Yeah.
Especially when somebody's put a good time up.
You know where they go. We're waiting on you. Waiting on you. Waiting on you, Magic.
There we go.
There you go. I'm going to go with Magic. I'm going to go with
tired, too.
Oh, he forgot the altitude, too.
Oh,
this is good. This is good. This is good. This is good. I'll tell you, I'm going with Magic. You know what? I'm going to go with the two-minute clock. The two-minute clock is going to be in the
thing. We might need to break out that Snicker bar.
Oh! It's Magic time.
123 was the time.
I couldn't get loose.
He couldn't get loose.
He's 20 years late. He's trying to get loose.
Told you I was a throwback.
He's going to kill us when he hears this. So,
hey, we care because we care.
Okay.
Anytime he can't get loose when you're 52 years old, it's hard to get loose.
Sean Marion, Diana Taurasi, and Dan Marley.
That was quick and painless.
Our winners.
That's not even fair. Oh, my goodness.
I can dance now. I got 15 in my pocket. Like,
oh. All right, Cheryl, take it away.
Oh, my goodness. This wasn't even fair. First and foremost, Diana, last year's WNBA Rookie of the Year, adding to the trophy case tonight.
Very nice. It worked out very nice. I mean, Dan, the veteran, brought us through.
Well, Sean, you guys, the Suns, have put more shots in the first half, three-point shots in the first half of the season. You guys made it look easy.
We're just having fun out there.
It was more, you guys actually looked like you had a strategy.
It was a lot.
Definitely. It was good. We were just making shots and just shooting them up there.
I got to go to Thunder, Dan. And you know what? It wasn't even fair. This is in your range. And as a veteran, you're wearing a lot of Bengay. Are you okay? Physically, you all right?
I'm all right. I was more worried about that three-point shot than that one. Like you said, that's my range. But I was playing with two all-stars, so it was a lot of fun.
All right. Congratulations. Ladies and gentlemen, 2005 Shooting Stars, the champs.
There they are, and that trio from Phoenix wins it. Great to see Magic Johnson and Alex English and Adrian Dantley. We're live from NBA All-Stars Saturday night in Denver, Colorado.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to the Sportsnet studios. I'm Jody Vance. I wish I could be the bearer of better news from today's National Hockey League labor talks in New York. Unfortunately, on a day that began with optimism reigning supreme, things have ended very badly as the two sides have again failed to come to terms on a new collective bargaining agreement.
At the invitation of the NHL, we came to New York today to continue discussions with them. We met for about 6.5 hours. Mario Lemieux and Wayne Gretzky joined the meetings today. It became apparent as we got into the meeting that the parties were, in fact, much further apart than everybody thought we were on Tuesday. No progress was made, and no further meetings will be scheduled.
I think there was a misconception that the two sides were close. I think it came from, frankly, it came from the side of ownership and certainly general managers and some players and fans and media. So, you know, I think it was crystal clear from our standpoint that we weren't, and that was evident today.
Here is what Wayne Gretzky, the Coyotes' managing partner, had to say. Mario and I were happy to be part of the process, and everyone seemed to work very hard together. We had a constructive meeting, and we only hope that they will continue meeting for the betterment of the NHL and its fans. Player owner of the Pittsburgh Penguins, Mario Lemieux, the Marvelous One, says, quote, I hope all parties continue talking and come to a solution for the betterment of the game. I certainly appreciate the work of Gary and Bill. I've done for a lot more now that I have been part of one of these sessions. Ah, yes, driving rain at the Nissan Open meant no play today at Riviera in Los Angeles. They will attempt to get the remainder of round two and all of round three in tomorrow, with the first group teeing it up at 7:30 a.m. Pacific, 10:30 Eastern time.
Who was
time.
That? Who was that? Was that number four? Was that the mighty number four that you just saw? That's all right. Let him go. Oh, Chris, open your hand. Be careful, baby. Let's not hurt your body.
Only a mother can watch a basketball game like that. That was Chris Bosh's mother. You want to see more from her? Well, join us at 7:30 Eastern as we roll out our pregame NBA All-Star show tomorrow, where we will unveil the Bosch Cam. For more on all of this and the very latest from around the world of sports, stick around following the NBA All-Star festivities for Sportsnet News. Until then, everyone, make it a great night.
Non-stop, y'all, to the beat, y'all. The body rock, y'all, so let's rock.
We're back in Denver moments ago. Kieran Hannon, Vice President, Brand for Radio Shack Corporation, presented the Radio Shack Shooting Stars Championship Trophy to Phoenix. They only missed four shots. They were absolutely terrific. Here are tonight's NBA.com fan poll results for the Radio Shack Shooting Stars competition. Now let's send it over to our public address announcer, Jonathan Wild.
Challenge competitors. From the Seattle Sonics, at 6'1", Luke Rindauer. From the Washington Wizards, at 6'3", Gilbert Arenas. From the Phoenix Suns, at 6'3", Steve Nash. And from your Denver Nuggets, at 5'5", Earl Boykins. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2005 PlayStation Skills Challenge.
So this is the PlayStation Skills Challenge, highlighting some of the top point guards in the NBA, featuring a two-round timed obstacle course, as you can see some of the things they will go through. The dribbling, passing, and shooting stations abounding all over the floor. And some of the rules to pay particular attention to: the two rounds and two players with the fastest times will advance to the finals, and in the event of a tie in either round, tie players will repeat the course. Players must rebound the same ball if they miss, and that is the prize money right there. First, bring in $25,000. Second place, $15,000. Third and fourth, $5,000.
The funniest thing I heard about this was Gilbert Arenas said, "I'm going to have trouble making the bounce pass," and he's a point guard. That's hilarious.
Log on to who will win the PlayStation Skills Challenge, and let's go to Cheryl Miller.
Well, I can tell you right now, Steve Nash will not have a problem making the bounce pass, and Steve, already Phoenix has set the tone tonight. Is the pressure on?
Well, the pressure is on. You know, I'm expecting big things from Q and Joe and Amari as well, so I feel a lot of heat.
All right, what part of the obstacle course are you a little bit nervous about?
Well, with all the bumps and bruises running through the, around the court itself. But I think the bounce pass and all the passes in general are the most unfamiliar to us.
All right, good luck tonight.
Thank you.
All right, let's send it back to you guys.
Since the 94-95 season, we've had a guy that has had 11 assists a season, and that's exactly what he's averaging right now. John Stockton was the guy then. Who's your favorite of this, Charles?
I'm going to go with Earl Boykin because I think he got a chance to be in the best. He's probably the best guy in the NBA, baseline to baseline with the basketball.
Steve?
I like Earl also. He was in it last year. He's got the experience, and he's such a good shooter. To me, the key is that top of the key jump shot. If you miss that a couple times, you're done.
I'll take Steve Nash, and for the final word, Kenny the Jet.
I'm going with Steve Nash because I think overall he's accustomed to passing more than any of those three guys. The rest of these guys are shooters.
Like you.
Yeah, no question.
The greatest shooter ever, right here,
shooter.
Right sitting.
Greatest shooter not in the NBA.
The white flag has been raised.
He's giving it up. When Charles says it, then I'm good.
I'd like to see you and Charles go at each other.
I think you tell me enough how great you are.
NBA All-Star Saturday night continues from Hawkins Denver after this on TNT.
We'll be right back.
Don't miss NBA All-Star Weekend. Sportsnet News' Barry Davis covers all the events from the Rookie Sophomore Challenge to the Slam Dunk Contest and the All-Star Game itself. NBA All-Star Weekend coverage on Sportsnet News. More hoops, less commercials. The NCAA Tournament starts March 15th on Rogers Sportsnet.
It's Canada's Lobster Fest, the one time of year when butter has a higher calling. Lobster Fest is back, only at Red Lobster.
Hell wants him.
What were those things?
They were after me.
Heaven won't take him.
It's personal, isn't it?
They don't like you, John.
Earth needs him.
Something's coming. I can feel it.
Keanu Reeves. Constantine.
Now playing.
Globe and Mail. It's not just news, it's a conversation.
Well, I had a dream. I stood beneath an orange sky.
The multifunctional element.
Yes, I had a dream. I
from Honda.
Stood beneath an orange sky.
Where will it take you?
It's Canada's Lobster Fest, the one time of year when butter has a higher calling. Lobster Fest is back, only at Red Lobster.
Welcome back to Denver, Colorado, and NBA All-Stars Saturday night presented by America Online with Kenny the Jet, Sir Charles, and Steve Kerr. This is Kevin Harlan. The PlayStation Skills Challenge is upon us. These are the competitors. Luke Ridnour runs the things up in Seattle. Gilbert Arenas having a terrific year with the Washington Wizards. Steve Nash.
MVP so far.
Right, that's exactly right, with the Phoenix Suns. And Earl Boykin.
First to the PlayStation Skills Challenge.
5'5 player for the Denver Nuggets.
Isn't that an oxymoron?
Something like that.
Big 5'5 player.
Plays big, baby.
That's like
plays
using
big.
Kenny and Smart in the same with lunch.
Hey, Charles like, and diet.
Hey, Charles and skinny. That's an oxymoron.
Or just a moron.
You know, one thing that really bugs me.
That's twice in one, like 30 seconds he's used there. That's terrific.
And he'll come up with a broken clock right twice a day.
There's Lou Ridnour.
And this boy having a really good season.
Yeah, he's a good player.
And Seattle's the surprise team in the NBA this year.
That's the toughest
That's
pass.
Tough, yep.
But if you throw it one hand, you should do like a bounce pass like if you throw it in a game. See, all these guys can shoot. They're not going to have problems with that shoot.
I think it's going to take something in the low 30s to win. Baron Davis ran away with this thing last year. He was about 28, 29 seconds, I think. That was a good run by Ridnour.
Decent.
Decent. 35.4.
4 seconds.
Luke Ridnour, second NBA season. Now here's Gilbert Arenas.
I wish the Wizards would go back to the Bullets. I hate that thing, the Wizards. Don't even sound good at all. I like them much better when they were the Bullets. They had a much better team, too.
Yeah, but they wear the orange jerseys. They wear the orange jerseys. Does that mean Gilbert's going to wear the orange shoes to go with
him? He's got orange shoes on.
That's ugly stuff. That's ugly stuff. Talk about the fastest guy in the league. This guy is a candidate for sure. See, Gilbert might get it. If he can pass it, he's going to struggle with the passing.
Oh, he called it.
Oh, yeah, I think he knows where the rim is, though.
What's up with this little sidearm deal these guys are doing?
19 seconds. You know, I'm glad he made the All-Star team. He's had a fantastic first half of the season. Him and Antoine Jameson.
He's in the top three in three-point field goals made, steals, and in points. He is in a great week.
That's how I feel with you. You get him up in the game, too.
Get him all up.
He just wants to shoot all the balls.
What happens if you don't make
it? He just throws on purpose. Shot a three.
You know what Kenneth said? He just wants to shoot it.
He missed it on purpose.
He missed him on purpose.
And Ridenour already has the advantage, 51.7 on the performance of Gilbert Arenas of the Washington Wizards wearing the throwback Bullets uniform tonight.
I don't remember that throwback. Did you ever play against that jersey?
No,
it was always red, white, and blue, wasn't it?
Yeah. Well, that's probably when Kevin was young.
Steve Nash.
Steve's going to win this. This might be a clean sweep Saturday night for Phoenix.
You know, somebody asked me if I think Steve Nash should be MVP. It's either him or Shaquille O'Neal. It doesn't go to the best player. The MVP goes to the guy who's having the best season.
Oh
my God.
Throw the alley-oop. No, you already made it.
They should give him a trophy anyway. If you can walk around with your hair looking like that, you deserve something. He's never going to get a perk commercial with hair like that.
The time to beat 35.4.
I told you, he got it. That's my guy. Lay it in.
Nobody picked him. I picked him.
I picked him
before you did.
Hey, okay, excuse me.
It's not over yet.
He hasn't won yet.
He's got in the finals. First place. There's one more to go.
He'll be in the finals.
And you two guys picked Earl Boykin.
Yeah, that's right.
And he's coming up next.
The top two will go to the finals, but right now Steve Nash at 31.4 is there.
This top of the eight. A clean sweep for Phoenix. The dunk contest in three along with these two.
You like Stoudemire in the dunk contest.
Yeah. I think it's going to because of the way the night is going. You can see it. It's kind of building up the momentum.
Earl Boykins is the second smallest player ever to play in the NBA. 5'3", Muggsy Bogues.
This guy's incredible. You know, he bench presses like 350
right.
pounds.
Yes.
Charles, that means he'll bench press you.
Hey, he got to get a little bit stronger to lift me up.
There it is, got that.
Hey, if he can't get the 350, he can't get me.
He's got to hurry.
This is the one.
He's got to beat 35.4.
Oh, he's got it. He's got it.
You see, he's gone.
He's out of there.
And so it's Boykins.
That's why we picked him.
Against Nash. Right.
But we got Nash over here.
Hey, so we're all right.
Uh-huh.
Four of us are on top so far.
It's the first time that's ever happened in TNT history. All four of us were right.
Very excited. Charles has got his voice back, and we're all on top so far. Right?
Yeah, he found a pillow. That's how he got his voice back.
No, I want to thank the nurse, the doctors, four lady doctors at the hospital. I got to give them some love. They took care of the touchdown.
We'll be back for the final of the PlayStation Skills Challenge. Boykins against Nash on TNT Saturday night.
NBA All-Star Weekend continues on Rogers Sportsnet. It's East versus West, and defense is optional. The game's best square off at the annual NBA All-Star Game. Coverage begins tomorrow at 7:30 Eastern, 4:30 Pacific on Rogers Sportsnet.
You may not remember what time dinner's at. Whether it was a left or a right. Or what you were supposed to pick up on the way. But the one thing you won't forget is the ride. The 2005 Nissan Altima.
New Juicy Fruit Blue is here, and I'm telling the world. Get your skis shined up, grab a stick of Juicy Fruit. The taste is gonna move ya. Take a sniff, pull it out. The taste is gonna move ya when you pop it in your mouth. Juicy Fruit is gonna move ya. The juice is
off,
it gets right.
Sweet.
New Juicy Fruit Blue. Sweet.
Men don't like to shave. They'd rather light their shorts on fire or eat dirt. Easy, fellas. Nivea helps soothe your skin after shaving. With moisturizers and vitamins, Nivea for Men Aftershave Balm soothes and improves the look of your skin. Nivea for Men. More evolved skincare.
Is this the help desk?
Yes, sir.
I need help with this.
What is it?
It's my invention.
What's wrong with it?
Nothing.
So what's the problem?
Everyone's going to want one.
I see.
My company's small. This is huge.
You need to grow fast.
Exactly.
Can I see it?
Have a look.
Whoa.
Help desk.
I give you my word.
Keeping our word is standard. Standard Life.
The championship is coming. The NCAA tournament starts March 15th on Rogers Sportsnet. Don't miss NBA All-Star Weekend. Sportsnet News' Barry Davis covers all the events from the Rookie Sophomore Challenge to the Slam Dunk Contest and the All-Star Game itself. NBA All-Star Weekend coverage on Sportsnet News.
To TNT.
Friday, March 11th.
Who is he?
My name is Gladiator. Father to a murdered son, husband to a murdered wife, and I will have my vengeance.
Three nights in a row, Gladiator, starting March 11th at 8 on TNT. We know drama.
That's a great movie.
That is a terrific movie. There's Steve Nash.
Can't be as good as that Turning Hooch y'all showed last week.
The what?
Turning Hooch last week. There's no Turning Hooch.
Earl Boykin against Steve Nash, and these are the finals of the PlayStation Skills Challenge.
When he goes around these calls, he's out of there.
Boykins had a time of 32.6 the first time he went around. And he looks like he's ahead of that right now.
This is big, the shot. The shot is going to be big in this round. Whoever hits the shot.
Oh, he's in trouble now.
Being in trouble. He got it. He's all right. He's out of here now. Whoa, look at that boy go. He's out of there. That's going to be tough to beat right there.
No, I think Steve is 30. I'll give Steve 32 on this. He'll miss one jumper. That'll be the difference, but he'll make 32 seconds.
He's got a cushion, though. He's got a, you know, he can afford one or two bad passes or a missed shot.
I thought he was going to miss the layup for a second.
He traveled. They call traveling.
They don't call traveling in the NBA anymore.
It's a skills composition. No traveling.
Uh-oh.
See what I'm saying?
If he makes this, it's
cash.
This is cash.
Are you kidding me?
This is cash.
It's over.
Are you kidding me?
It's a clean sweep for Phoenix tonight. I'm predicting.
And $25,000 to Steve Nash.
Been a pretty good year for that guy.
Yeah, he's had a great season. So Phoenix won the first event. They've won the second event.
Clean sweep. I tell you, the momentum is building. It's building and flowing. And you got two guys. You got two chances in the next contest.
Wow. 25.8 seconds.
I don't think I could go up and down to 25 right now.
Take I know Charles about 3 minutes and 25 seconds.
You can, Steve. You can do that easily in 25 minutes.
I would pay to see Charles make that point. Really
well, you got to have it, Aaron. If I do it, you're going to have to pay me.
All right, Cheryl, take it away.
Thanks a lot, Kevin. Well, tonight, Steve, it looks like it's turning into an all-Phoenix event. Fastest time ever. How difficult was it?
It was tough. You know, I think those guys are all quicker than I am, so I tried to keep up with them and made my shot, luckily.
You know, the shots weren't a problem for you. It was that chest pass over there. Was it because you're used to the alley-oops in Phoenix?
Yeah, it wasn't fancy enough. I thought we should have thrown it behind the back or something.
All right, congratulations.
Thanks, Joe.
So here in Denver tonight, NBA All-Star Saturday, presented by America Online, will continue. It's been all Phoenix so far on TNT.
Call my name. This week, take a little trip to Sin City with Sportsnet News. Tonight, join Sean McCormick and get inside access to the violent world of Ultimate Fighting.
Vegas, baby, Vegas. All week long, only on Sportsnet News.
You may not remember what time dinner's at. Whether it was a left or a right. Or what you were supposed to pick up on the way. But the one thing you won't forget is the ride. The 2005 Nissan Altima.
The Pump by Reebok. Available at Foot Locker.
New Tylenol Cold with Cool Burst, demo number 6. How fast will he feel the Cool Burst sensation? Oh. Oh my. New Tylenol Cold with Cool Burst coating. A cool, soothing sensation you can feel instantly.
You may not remember what time dinner's at. Whether it was a left or a right. Or what you were supposed to pick up on the way. But the one thing you won't forget is the ride. The 2005 Nissan Altima.
Is this the help desk? I need help.
What kind of help?
Dinosaurs and robots and outer space and why the sky is blue. Lots of stuff.
Don't you learn that in school?
I don't go to school. It's too far. I live on a farm in China.
I see.
Is there room for me over there?
We're virtual. There's always room.
Yes.
Help desk.
Hey, new Juicy Fruit Blue is here, and I'm telling the world. Get your skis shined up, grab a stick of Juicy Fruit. The taste is gonna move ya. Take a sniff, pull it out. The taste is gonna move ya when you pop it in your mouth.
Sweet.
New Juicy Fruit Blue. Sweet.
And moments ago, Andrew House, the executive vice president, PlayStation Skills Challenge Championship, Phoenix Suns, Steve.
About to?
Nash, not Kerr, but I appreciate the thought.
You did.
I'm sorry. I got
you
Steve.
You know
how fast.
You're right.
Well, you so much.
Yeah, other than the dribbling and passing and running, we're exactly
identical. And hairstyle.
Hey, Steve, no disrespect. If you couldn't shoot, that would really be a reason for you to be alive.
Thank you.
You strictly got through life as a shooter.
Well, who picked Nash? Kenny and I picked Nash.
You can't, but don't hurt yourself. Pat yourself on the back.
Well, no, why?
You want to pull out your scrapbook? I mean,
the thing is,
you guys did fine. It's okay.
But it was only four guys. You got lucky.
No, there's a difference between playing the game and knowing the game, and then we played it and know it.
Thank you, Chet. Thank you, Chet. Let's go to our PA announcer, Jonathan Wild.
All right, fans. It's time to find out who's the best long-distance shooter in the NBA. Please welcome the players for the Foot Locker 3-Point Shootout. From the Philadelphia 76ers, Kyle Korver. From the Phoenix Suns, Joe Johnson. Also from the Phoenix Suns, Quentin Richardson. From the Seattle SuperSonics, Vladimir Admonovich. Also from the Seattle Sonics, the 2001 three-point champion, Ray Allen. And 2004 defending shootout champion, from your Denver Nuggets, Deshaun Leonard.
This is going to be a lot of fun. We've got, number one, the 6 points max per rack, 30 points max per round. The two rounds, top three shooters advancing to the finals. Prize money is right there in front of you. As you can see, first place again garnering $25,000, second $15,000 and down the line. Log on to NBA.com or AOL. Keyword NBA.com to vote for who you think will win tonight's Foot Locker three-point shootout.
What's interesting. The guy's lost up in BFE Ramadovic, but that boy can flat-out shoot it. Don't be surprised if he steals this thing.
Yeah, Ramadovic,
I'm holding you to that.
I'm telling you. I picked Korver last year. He let me down, so I dumped him.
I'm going Joe Johnson. I switched my pick.
Let's go to Cheryl Miller. Cheryl?
Thanks a lot, Robert. Sean, I was there when you tore your Achilles. Haven't gone through it. I can't believe you're here defending your title. How'd you get back so quickly?
Well, I've been rehabbing it, and I'm ahead of schedule right now, so I want to take it day by day and make sure I'm 100% before I try to do anything. But right now, this is the only thing that I'm capable of doing right now.
Now, Ray Allen won in 2001. You're defending your title. Is he your main competition? Is that who you're looking over your shoulder?
Well, it's everybody. Everybody can shoot, so it's going to be some tough competition tonight. So I'm going to try to hang in there.
Any strategy? Any worries about the Achilles?
No, it feels good right now, and I'm going to give it a shot.
All right, good luck.
All right, thanks.
All right, send it over to you guys.
All right, Cheryl, thank you very much. I'm going to go with... I think I'm going to go with Ray Allen.
I went with Ray Allen, but I'm going to change my pick.
Already? What, did you just watch warm-ups or something?
I'm going to just tell you something. Ray Allen is a safe pick. I'm going to go with Ramanovic. I told you, he's stuck up in Seattle, but I'm going to go with him this year. He's up there with Ichiro.
He's a good player.
He's a great shooter, though.
He's a good player. He's not only a shooter, but I'm going to go. Ichiro hasn't done anything, Steve, but I deal with this every time.
Seattle. He's stuck up there in the middle of nowhere.
I like Korver, and I'll tell you one reason why. The altitude up here actually is serious. You saw how we were huffing and puffing when we shot.
Yeah, but y'all have been.
Yeah, that's true. But Korver was here last night in the rookie game, made 7 threes. He's blown out the wind. He's ready to go. I think he's got his second wind. He's used to this altitude. He's also a great shooter. He shot well last year as a rookie, too.
I'm going Phoenix. It's going to be a clean sweep.
Which one?
Phoenix.
Which one?
I'm going Phoenix.
You can't pick both. You got to pick one.
I'm going Joe Johnson.
All right.
I like that pick. That's
I'm
a good
one. Joe Johnson.
We'll come back to Denver right after this on TNT.
Stroking three after three after three.
The NBA is on Rogers Sportsnet and Raptors NBA TV. Just subscribe to the 5 Sportsnet channels, Sportsnet East, Sportsnet Ontario, Sportsnet West, Sportsnet Pacific, and Sportsnet HD, plus Raptors NBA TV. 380 NBA games this season, including 68 in high definition. For more info, call your television service provider.
Bring it home, baby. Bring it home.
Get the most hoops on Rogers Sportsnet and Raptors NBA TV all season long.
It's Canada's Lobster Fest, the one time of year when butter has a higher calling. Lobster Fest is back, only at Red Lobster.
It has more standard safety features than any SUV in its class. It is the only small SUV to earn the highest possible ratings of all crash tests by the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety. It has been voted the 2004 Best Small SUV by Car and Driver. The new all-wheel drive Subaru Forester, a 210 horsepower security blanket you can test drive. Subaru Forester, full-time all-wheel drive, maximum 5-star protection.
In a town full of pretenders.
Give me that eyebrow thing. Oh, look at that.
Everyone wants to be a gangster.
My bad, dog.
It's my wife's cousin.
But Chili Palmer is the real thing.
I like to be spontaneous and creative.
We got jokes?
This ain't cool, man!
Be cool.
It's impossible that you're stupid.
Stop hating. Stop participating.
Starts Friday, March 4th.
Tempted by the fruit of another. Tempted, but the truth is discovered. What's been
introducing new Dentine Tango. Intense berry flavor, so juicy and so tempting. You've never done a tango like this before. New Dentine Tango. Taste the forbidden fruit.
It's Canada's Lobster Fest, the one time of year when butter has a higher calling. Lobster Fest is back, only at Red Lobster.
Welcome back to NBA All-Stars Saturday night, presented by America Online from the Mile High City of Denver, Colorado. Tonight's HD helicopter coverage is being brought to you by the United States Air Force, and it is a very festive time here in the Rockies. Last night in the Got Milk Rookie Challenge, the sophomores defeated the rookies 133-106. The trio of Dwayne Wade, LeBron James, and Carmelo Anthony led the way. Andre Iguodala made the move of the night, though, with this around-the-back layup, and Kyle Korver hit 7 of 10 three-pointers. Fan favorite Carmelo Anthony had a game-high 31 points and took home the MVP trophy. So once again, let's take a look at our group tonight. Kyle Korver of Philadelphia, Joe Johnson with the Phoenix Suns, Quentin Richardson, who's taken more threes than any player in the NBA this year, out of the Suns, Radmanovic at Seattle, also his teammate Ray Allen, and Vashawn Leonard. And again, this Leonard story is really something, and I'm going to ask the two shooters here, nothing against you, Charles, but, you know, Achilles, ankle, knee, jumping, legs for the shot, I mean, that's a lot to ask of a guy who tore his Achilles a couple months ago.
Yeah, but he can shoot. I mean, I was going to say once a shooter, always a shooter, but I disproved that theory yesterday when I shot against Kenny. But no, Vashawn Leonard can shoot it. I think maybe the last couple of racks, you're right, fatigue could become a factor. But this is great. I'm happy for him. I'm happy that he's out here.
Here's your guy, Kevin. Kevin, who you think got a higher field goal percentage in NBA history?
You.
So yeah, I need to say, I can tell these two guys some about shooting.
If I dunked everything too, I would have.
A dunk counts as a shot, you know.
Yeah, but I ain't 6'5 and 350.
I ain't 350 either.
Okay.
I had lunch earlier today. I'm 357 away.
So he's got 4 right now. And like, you like him, but I just don't think that you can. He's more of a game shooter, rhythm. He's actually more of a player than a shooter.
Yeah, he's made all 3 money balls. He's at 11 now. I think you got to get to about 17 or 18 to advance to the finals. So he's in decent shape right now.
If you want to put that guy on a team with a big man,
oh, it's a wrap.
It would be a wrap. A guy that has to get doubled, kind of like you, Steve.
Yeah, he needs to go play with Tim Duncan.
Oh, my goodness. It'd be scary.
Kyle Korver, final shots. The money ball is worth 2 points.
Who picked him?
Not me.
Somebody did.
Nobody picked Korver. No, we're all
Korver. No, Steve did.
Oh, Steve. Oh, yeah, he had 7 last night. That's why you picked
him. Well, he should have picked him last night, dude.
He had 14. He had 14.
I did pick him last night.
He's 24 hours late.
Maybe Steve thought he could count himself around.
Just to give you some perspective, it is in the 20th year in any round is 20 by Craig Hodges. In 1986.
Which will never be beat.
He was the master.
Never be beat.
He had that little bunny hop before each shot.
Such
he
great
had it
rhythm.
Down.
Joe Johnson, 46% above the arc this season.
I like that.
And hey, listen, Joe Johnson and Quentin Richardson should take Steve Nash out to dinner once a week. To the best restaurant.
Joe Johnson from Arkansas.
That's amazing. 10% better.
Yeah. one seed, you're right.
Steve Nash, they owe him lunch.
I always shot better when I played with Michael Jordan and Tim Duncan, I know that. I mean, so it's all about who you're playing with and the quality of the attempts you're getting.
Well, we should have had Michael Jordan pass it to you yesterday.
And he should have Steve Nash pass it to him right now.
Hey, I don't think him and Quinn Richardson can hit a shot without Steve Nash giving it to him.
Steve, step on the floor. Nash, where are you?
You know, this is a tough competition, Kenny. I know you were in it once, but you get awfully nervous out here. This is so foreign to these guys because this isn't something that they do, and all of a sudden you're on an island by yourself out there.
He may not finish. Look what the time is left. He's got a whole other rack to go.
He's not going to finish.
He's on vacation right now. It's all-star break.
Who picked Joe Johnson amongst us?
I picked Phoenix, but they made me say Joe.
I'm just telling you, those guys that... What the hell? You know how much I love Shaq, but his half thing ain't working. I'm serious. That half thing ain't working for Shaq, y'all. I love Shaq. I respect Shaq, but that half thing gotta go.
Hey, can I tell you, these next four shooters, are this could be fun to watch these next four guys.
Well, if this competition were about who could take the most shots in a minute, this guy would
Richardson.
Win.
Richardson. Yes, sir.
That's all he does. And I'd like to see him down on the block a little bit more. As strong as he is, I think he settles too much.
Yeah, but the way the Suns play, Kamari's down on the box. No room down there for him.
See, the big thing is you got to make one of your first two.
No, the big thing you got to do for these two guys, they got to get Steve Nash passing it to him.
Oh, my gosh, they're killing my theory.
Oh, man. See why I told y'all Steve Nash should be first at MVP?
Well, the toughest thing to do in this competition is to get out of a rut. When you miss three in a row, all of a sudden that collar starts to tighten up, and it's tough to find that rhythm.
Why not have a guy passing the ball? Because that's how you get it in the game, as opposed to pulling out of a rack, which is so unnatural.
Right? Hey, Kevin, we're not going to change the rule because two guys can't do it.
Come on.
We've had to test. It's been entertaining for 20 years.
Hey, you know what? For the slam dunk competition, they're going to have something.
He's in it now. He made all five on that rack, and he's right in it if he can get hot here.
The money ball might be big as it comes down.
He's got the corners.
This one was 2 points. Oh, and he got that.
Shooting out of the corners was tough for him.
So he's tied.
He shoots most of his threes at extended.
Yeah, extended out about 6 feet.
So Kyle Korver from Philadelphia and Quentin Richardson from the Phoenix Suns tied through three on the Foot Locker 3-point shootout.
Michael has the ball. Again guarded by Sean Marion. The fadeaway. Here's Shaquille O'Neal.
Shaq's been great.
You gotta love Shaq.
The NBA is on Rogers Sportsnet and Raptors NBA TV. Just subscribe to the 5 Sportsnet channels: Sportsnet East, Sportsnet Ontario, Sportsnet West, Sportsnet Pacific, and Sportsnet HD. Plus, Raptors NBA TV. And get over 380 NBA games this season, including 68 in high definition. For more info, call your television service provider.
Bring it home, baby. Bring it home.
Get the most hoops on Rogers Sportsnet and Raptors NBA TV all season long.
Master 3. And Mazda 3 Sport anticipates so much of what you want and need in a car, it'll make your head spin. The remarkably responsive, yet truly affordable Mazda 3 and Mazda 3 Sport.
Hey, new Juicy Fruit Blue is here, and I'm telling the world. Get your skis shined up, grab a stick of Juicy Fruit. The taste is gonna move ya. Take a sniff, pull it out. The taste is gonna move ya when you pop it in your mouth. Juicy Fruit is gonna move ya. The juice is
awesome,
it gets right.
Sweet.
New Juicy Fruit Blue. Sweet. The new 170 horsepower Corolla XRS.
Whoa.
Once you're into it, you're really into it. The new lightning-fast Corolla XRS. Once you're into it, you're really into it.
Tomorrow on Sportsnet News, we look at the weird.
Quite possibly the worst timeout entertainment we have seen in 17 years of watching NBA basketball.
The wonderful.
Oh.
And the downright wacky.
Hey there, Carol.
Oh, hell.
And it's not funny.
The misplays of the week. Tomorrow on Sportsnet News.
About the country.
From executive producer Steven Spielberg and DreamWorks Television, a six-week television event into the West this June on TNT.
Here are the standings, and only three players have shot so far, three to come in the Foot Locker three-point shootout. Charles Barkley's here along with Steve Kerr and Kenny the Jet Smith on our NBA All-Star Saturday Night coverage, and here is Vladimir Radmanovic.
This is my guy right here. Quick question, Steve. Don't you start to shoot better as the rounds go on and on?
And remember, it used to be three rounds.
Right.
So now it's two, but the whole thing about the first round is just survival. Just get to the next round, and then you get much more comfortable.
All right, here's our quiz tonight. Who is the last and the only Seattle Supersonic to ever win this competition?
Ray Allen.
Nope.
It wasn't a Sonic.
The year was 1989.
Oh, I know. Dale Ellis.
University of Tennessee.
I learned how to shoot threes from watching Dale Ellis.
Really?
Yeah, he taught me how to shoot threes one offseason when we were doing a charity game. I changed the way I shot. I didn't shoot threes my first 4 years in the NBA.
Chuck, you're in trouble.
I'm deadly in trouble.
He's a good player, though. I think if they play one-on-one, he'll win, though.
You know what? I still got Ray Allen, though.
I pick Ray Allen.
No, he's got like eight guys in the seven-man field.
I picked Ray Allen before the day started.
No. I got Larry Bird. Okay, you want to just throw names out. You're going to have a look. Everybody who have a shot.
Then I'll take Steve Kerr.
I'll take Craig Hodges, too.
No, that's Steve Kerr, not a good bet. He threw that today.
Meanwhile, Korver and Richardson are over there quietly cheering because they're still in this thing at 14.
From Yugoslavia, Vladimir Radmanovic. And we got Ray Allen coming up, and only six for Radmanovic. He's out.
Wow, good pick, Charles.
Heck of a player, though.
Remember now, we take the top three for the finals.
He can jump. Oh, this is 3 points.
I'll tell you, experience in this event means so much. I mean, once you get used to it a little bit, It's a totally different deal.
I can't believe they let Ray Allen. He's only shooting 37%.
Ray Allen had the long-distance shootout championship to himself for the 2001 All-Star Game. You go back four consecutive years in the NBA, he led the league in three-point made and three-point attempted baskets in 2001, 2, and 2003.
Well, the amazing thing to me is that he creates his three-point shots off the dribble at will. I mean, he can get any shot he wants.
This is like really easy for him. The shot is, it's not forced, it's effortless.
It's a big one there.
It's a money ball, but he misses that 2-pointer.
He needs a strong finish.
But see, this is his natural range in a game. That's why he shoots it so well in a game.
There he goes.
He's a good corner shooter, too. That'll help him on the last
rack. Right now, he's in the finals, but this rack is big.
Yeah, he's better from the corner, though. Told you what I tell you. He's great from the corner. That's his spot.
He's got to have the money.
One more for 2 points.
He didn't get it.
He's at 13, so right now he would be in the finals. We got 2-14, 1-13, and we got one more shooter left.
Well, he's not in the finals then, Ernie. I mean, you know.
Ernie, how are you?
Ernie. Whoever you are.
Kevin look a little bit like Ernie.
Thank you. I take that as a compliment.
I mean, all ugly people look alike. We don't put y'all in any classification.
No, for right now, he would be in. We got one more to go. But for right now, he would be in the finals. It's like the top three, Charles.
No disrespect either. You know Ernie Johnson.
I like Ernie Johnson.
We love Ernie, but you know Ernie Johnson.
Look, and you're no Doug Collins.
They put Rashawn's season numbers up. He's 2 for 6. He played in one game.
Oh, he's 2 for 6.
Yeah,
he's terrible
for the season.
I tell you one thing about it. Like, do you ever go to a park and like an old man is just knocking down shots? You don't really need legs all the time. So him being hurt And you can see he put on a couple pounds.
Oh, yeah,
a couple pounds.
Oh, my gosh.
Because he can't work out. If you can't do cardio, it's pretty tough to stay slim.
Huge. A couple, that's an understatement. That's like calling Titanic a small boat accident. Hey, Kenny, I put on a couple pounds, too.
Hey, Chuck, he might have you.
I mean, he is gigantic.
We may. I'm going to ask you, we can wear the same underwear tonight.
That's Biggie Smalls now.
Well, he's in good shape.
He's not in good shape.
He is Charles Barkley's shape. He rounds.
He's not in good shape.
Oh, and he gets the 2-point money ball at the end. He leads them all. He has not played since opening night when he tore an Achilles. 5 of 5 on the money ball shots. And the defending champ will play in the finals.
Ray Allen.
Yep, Ray Allen's out. Did anybody, none of us picked Rashawn Leonard, did we?
That's because he ain't played in one game all year.
It's hard to pick a man you haven't seen.
But so my question is, do you think his conditioning going to hold up?
It's not holding up.
Let's
hold up his pants.
Let's check in with Cheryl Miller.
Okay, all you had to say was that let's throw it to Cheryl like I called Corbin. Kyle, this is your second time around. 14 in the first round. Did you feel very comfortable?
I thought I was done. I didn't think 14 would be good enough. But you survive another round. Hopefully it'll come out and be a little better this round.
Rashawn Leonard obviously hasn't played all season after rupturing his Achilles, and he pops in as a winner. Can you believe his effort?
On one leg, you guys what, 17? That's pretty good.
All right, see you in the finals. Right. Some of you guys. Sir.
This February on Rogers Sportsnet, we're your home for hoops. Sportsnet's the place for live coverage of the entire NBA All-Star Weekend. The AHL is here as Sportsnet continues its great games throughout the month. See all the hard hits and great goals as the Toronto Rock compete in the National Lacrosse League. And see the next wave of hockey's best as Sportsnet is home to CHL hockey. All this and more, all February, only on Rogers Sportsnet.
Introducing the 300-horsepower Acura RL. With voice-activated technology and super-handling all-wheel drive, power can be shifted front to rear, side to side, and while cornering, the outside rear wheel is accelerated for magnetic-like handling. The road will never be the same. The all-new Acura RL.
Hey, great party, man. Lots of ladies, huh? Oh, she's got hungry eyes, and I am an all-you-can-eat buffet.
Dodge Dakota.
Nice, yeah.
With the only V8 in its class.
This is gonna look great in our bedroom. You are such an...
And the most overall interior room.
Wonderful man.
The NBA is on Rogers Sportsnet and Raptors NBA TV. Just subscribe to the 5 Sportsnet channels. Sportsnet East, Sportsnet Ontario, Sportsnet West, Sportsnet Pacific, and Sportsnet HD. Plus, Raptors NBA TV.
Oh, boy!
And get over 380 NBA games this season, including 68 in high definition. For more info, call your television service provider.
Bring it home, baby. Bring it home.
Get the most hoops on TV all season long.
You're watching NBA All-Stars Saturday night, presented by America Online from Denver, Colorado, with Kenny the Jet Smith, Charles Barkley, Steve Kerr, and Kevin Harlan. A lot of fun so far. We are in the Foot Locker 3-point shootout. where Kyle Korver of the Philadelphia 76ers, Phoenix's Quentin Richardson, and Rashawn Leonard of the Denver Nuggets will compete as our three finalists, and Korver will go first.
I got to think the scores are going to be higher now. Everybody's comfortable. They're relaxed now a little bit. Getting past that first round is the key, and I think the scores will be up closer to 20 now.
And Korver has to be the favorite.
Because you picked him?
No.
No, I picked him.
Oh, you picked him.
Yeah, Charles picked Radmanovich. You got six points.
Right? Yeah, that's right.
That's a good pick.
Hey, remember, that's first place, and everybody that's coming second. At least my guy came in second.
I did pick Korver last year. Maybe I was just a year off.
I was a night off, I guess.
The uniform he's wearing from the Syracuse Nationals, the Nets that eventually became the Philadelphia franchise.
See, the one thing I think about him is that he's more of a player than a shooter. He shoots well, but he shoots well in the game because he knows how to get open and get in rhythm. So that's why I didn't really pick him.
He's starting to get in the groove now, though.
First of all, he can't do anything but shoot.
No, you haven't been watching these guys. He puts it on the floor. He's athletic.
Listen, I saw him at Creighton. He's a shooter.
That's his best attribute, but he does things as well in the game.
Korver finished third last year with 15 in the finals.
I think 15 might be his limit.
Yeah, we'll see. Here comes the money ball for two. He's already gone by 15, and he cut it. A big-time shot by Kyle Korver with 18 points.
That might have did it, that money ball.
He was 4-5 with the money ball in that round.
Well, that's the big one. He started finding his rhythm at the top of the circle and made a nice little comeback there at the end. And that those money balls are huge. If you can make all five of those, as Rashawn Leonard did, makes it pretty easy.
Steve, when you're in this competition, because you've been in it before, what are you thinking? I mean, you're not thinking like you're in a game. You're thinking such a different way.
I always thought before I entered the competition, I always thought I'd know exactly how many points I had. I never knew anything about points, time. I mean, you got to figure out the timing and the rhythm. That's why experience is so important in this thing.
But that's what makes Larry Bird's accomplishment when he did it more amazing, because he shot the last ball, knew he needed that, and he put his finger up knowing that that's the last ball he needed.
I mean,
that's
incredible. I'd finish up, and I'd look up at the scoreboard. I had no idea how many I had.
It took you that long to realize Larry Bird was smarter than Steve?
So Kyle Korver finishes hitting 5 of 6. Here's Quentin Richardson.
Volume shooter.
I told you, he the corners, he struggles.
Volume doesn't make any difference in this.
No, it doesn't. They all shoot 25 times.
Exactly. Anyway, you never have to worry about the shot clock running out on that boy right there.
No.
He going to get his FGAs. He got Danny Ainge disease.
A little flat on those first two racks.
You can make all of these.
Told you before, he leads the NBA in three-point attempts, but he's only shooting 36% from above the arc in the regular season. Now he's got 11 with a whole rack to go. The money ball for two.
Oh! Yes! I mean, I'm going with Phoenix. It's a Phoenix sweep coming up. I'm telling you,
puts a lot of pressure. He hits his last 9 shots. Right, finishes with 19.
It's the weekend of the Phoenix Sun.
Oh, really? You heard that somewhere before.
And Quentin Richardson just mirrored what he's done all season. He'll miss 10 in a row, then he'll make 10 in a row.
Yeah, what was that game, Steve, when he made like about 9-10 three-pointers in a game?
He's about as streaky as they come. Look at Brian and Jerry Colangelo up there fired up for their guy.
Called it. Yeah, although Kenny, I got to give you a little grief. You did not pick him. You picked Joe Johnson.
You forced me into something that I didn't
Kenny,
really
nobody
want
else
to
got to pick two guys.
Kenny,
you picked three.
Kenny, modesty is a wonderful quality. You should get familiar with it.
Okay. All I'm saying is it's going to be a Phoenix
modesty.
Weekend.
Modesty.
Does he know that word?
No. No way.
Okay, I had it wrong. Yeah, I want to say that.
He is the defending three-point shooting champion.
Needs 20 for the win. It's going to be tough.
Well, he's just got to get hot on two racks, it looks like.
He's got to make probably all four of these.
Not to get to 20. He's got to get really hot.
He's got it on these next two racks. He's got to be high.
And he is.
That boy is a great shooter when he's healthy too.
And that's what's Denver missing right now. No one spreads the floor. They have trouble scoring in half court.
That's exactly right.
That's why they would love to have a guy like Michael Redd if they could get him.
They can.
He's got to need all five balls to tie.
Boy, he's a great shooter, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
He's going to come up a little short. A good effort for a guy who's been out all season with that Achilles injury.
There's the future, Mrs. Richardson. Brandon. Quinn Richardson having a great season, has the big contract as he leaves the Los Angeles Clippers as a free agent and goes to Phoenix. He's playing on one of the top teams. He's been a headline maker. And Quinn Richardson hit his last nine to win it by one over Kyle Korver of the Philadelphia 76ers. Let's go to Cheryl Miller.
Come on, Q, step on up here and look like, first of all, Phoenix is making a run here in Denver, but talk about the second round. You look like you were more comfortable.
You do. You get more settled into your shots and you get more used to it. On the first round, you know, it's real, real quick. Come at you real quick.
All right, second competition coming up is a slam dunk. Amari Stoudemire is next. Is this going to be an all Phoenix Sun tonight?
That's what it's got to be. And then Steve Nash or somebody going to win the MVP tomorrow.
All right, congratulations. Let's go back to you, Kevin.
All right, Cheryl, thank you. And that was a sensational appearance by Richardson and Korver. The slam dunk is coming up next on TNT.
Welcome to the Sportsnet Studios, everybody. I'm Jody Vance. I got some good news, I got some bad news. The bad news is there is no good news from the National Hockey League labor talks in New York. Unfortunately, on a day where optimism reigns supreme in the morning, things have ended very badly as the two sides yet again have failed to come to terms on a new CBA.
The meeting was very civil. It was not acrimonious in any way, but it didn't accomplish anything. Everyone's clear on the result of the fact it accomplished nothing. And as I say, no further meetings are scheduled, nor do I see any need to have any meetings at the present time.
You know, a lot of their concern is that the small market teams can compete against the big market teams, and we wanted the big guys to help the small guys. And if they don't want to help each other, I don't know why they want us to be partners with them.
I know that today was not good and was far from not good. So you know what, the process continues, and certainly from both sides, it's not a good situation.
The season was over on Wednesday, and it is certainly not going to be resurrected.
Optimism is on ice in Vancouver as well, where Canuck coach Mark Crawford actually went through the steps of planning a short training camp. Now, as Dan Murphy reports, all those plans are off.
Like most fans of the game, Mark Crawford has been on a bit of an emotional roller coaster ride this past week. The head coach of the Vancouver Canucks was excited Tuesday, very disappointed Wednesday, and then found reason for optimism again on Saturday. Well, now that it appears that it's too late to save any sort of a season, Crawford is upset, but says it's all part of dealing with the ups and downs of the negotiating process.
It's no fun for anybody, but you know, we just have to trust in the powers that be, and hopefully they'll get the job done. And, you know, again, just leave it in their hands.
Last week they said they were ready to go back to square one. This is a positive step that they haven't done that.
Yeah, it is. At least it sounds as though, you know, they're working off the framework of where they were. And, like I said, let's hope that that they can find a resolution. And when it gets done, I still positively believe that, you know, we will be able to move forward. But let's get the deal done first and then talk about ways in which we will.
Crawford had been holding out hopes for a shortened season till the very last minute. In fact, on Saturday, he even made some preliminary calls in case he had to organize a training camp quickly. Now he just hopes the two sides can get something done so everything's back to normal in the fall. Dan Murphy, Sportsnet, Vancouver.
For more on all of this and the latest from around the world of sports, stick around following the NBA All-Star festivities here on Rogers Sportsnet. It is Sportsnet News. I'll have it all for you. Make it a great night, everyone. We'll see you soon.
bring them out. Bring them out, bring them out. Bring them out, bring them out.
Well, moments ago, Reuben Hannon, the Senior Vice President, Marketing, Foot Locker Incorporated, presented the Foot Locker three-point shootout champion trophy to Quentin Richardson of the Phoenix Suns. Phoenix has won all three events so far. Here are tonight's NBA.com fan poll results for the Foot Locker three-point shootout. Allen at the 54%. Now let's take a look at some of what the NBA players have been doing this week to help out the community right here in Denver.
This past week, the NBA family was giving back to the Denver community through a variety of exciting and impactful projects. The importance of reading was stressed through school visits.
At the court, everybody shake hands, and the guys split into two teams of four.
Then with an all-star reading rally that was held for more than 800 Denver area students. The NBA also held basketball clinics for members of the Junior NBA, Junior WNBA, and the Junior Rolling Nuggets programs. The clinics taught basketball fundamentals and reinforced the importance of teamwork and sportsmanship. NBA family members also lifted the spirits of patients and families during an emotional visit to the Children's Hospital of Denver. Finally, the NBA All-Star Legacy Project took place at the Owen Boys and Girls Club as Commissioner Stern was joined by current and former NBA players to dedicate a reading and learning center. The center, which is the 100th that the league has developed, is complete with thousands of books and literacy materials, as well as a state-of-the-art technology lab. Giving back to the community is a year-round global commitment for the NBA, its teams, and players as they work together to touch lives and make a difference all over the world.
Please direct your attention to the All-Star Saturday Night Stage and welcome All-Stars Grant Hill and Ray Allen.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Hope you're enjoying our All-Star Saturday Night's festivities. I'm Ray Allen of Seattle Supersonics.
And I'm Grant Hill of the Orlando Magic. Throughout this weekend, we want you all to have a good time because we know how much we enjoy these moments. But we also want to keep in everyone's mind that there's a greater cause than any dunk contest winner or MVP trophy that gets awarded this weekend.
Whether it's donating time reading to children, spending time with the elderly, or helping to feed the homeless, we can all make a difference. With the recent events in South Asia still weighing heavily on our minds, it should serve as a reminder that we should concern for all of our neighbors, near or far.
We hope you enjoy yourselves this weekend, and no matter who you are or where you're from, we can all give a little bit. Ladies and gentlemen, the Goo Goo Dolls.
Give a little bit of my love to you.
Thanks a lot.
Goo Goo Dolls! Please direct your attention to the video board for a special message from former Presidents George Bush and Bill Clinton.
In the aftermath of the tsunami disaster, America has risen to the challenge of helping those in the greatest need.
The NBA family has raised more than $4 million to support ongoing relief efforts to millions of survivors who've lost loved ones, homes, and communities.
Still, so much more needs to be done. If you've already contributed to this effort, thank you. If not, please visit usafreedomcorps.gov to find ways to give.
Every donation, no matter how small, will make a big difference. Thank you.
Thank you.
NBA All-Star Weekend on Rogers Sportsnet. Brought to you by Nissan. And by Nivea. Don't like to shave. They'd rather light their shorts on fire or eat dirt. Easy, fellas. Nivea helps soothe your skin after shaving. With moisturizers and vitamins, Nivea for Men Aftershave Balm soothes and improves the look of your skin. Nivea for Men. More evolved skincare.
Introducing Tylenol Ultra Relief. It's fast. It's tough. It's extra strength Tylenol, plus a pain relief enhancer for your tough headaches and migraine pain. New Tylenol Ultra Relief, when extra strength Tylenol isn't enough.
Right now, buy a specially marked 8-pack of Duracell batteries and get ready to pop the copper top. You could win one of three $10,000 cash prizes, valuable coupons, and free product. It could only take one pop to pop the copper top for $10,000.
Hey, Don, can we get your...
Just a minute, darling, just a minute.
This Quiznos real deal menu?
It's great.
$3.99 every day.
Not that, it's the taste.
$3.99.
It's the taste.
$3.99.
$3.99. You want to go?
Grapes? I'm a finesse player now.
Well, with those hands, you're not.
What did you say?
It was him, Ty.
Introducing the Quiznos Meatball Sandwich, one of six oven-toasted real deal sandwiches.
$3.99 every day.
Quiznos. Toasty.
The NBA on Rogers Sportsnet HD, featuring superior picture that's five times the resolution of an ordinary TV and a widescreen format that features more of the action. Catch the Celtics and Lakers in high definition Tuesday at 10:30 Eastern, 7:30 Pacific on Rogers Sportsnet HD. It's all about the money. You could win up to $250,000 in the Ericsson Ultimate Nassau Golf Tournament presented by Rogers Wireless. Take your game to the next level and be part of the action on Rogers Sportsnet, sponsored in part by Islands of the Bahamas. Register at ultimatenassau.com and for details.
Time to get above the rim with the Sprite Rising Star Slam Dunk competitors. At 6'6", from the New Orleans Hornets, J.R. Smith. At 6'9", from the Atlanta Hawks, Josh Smith. At 6'10", from the New Orleans Hornets, Chris Anderson. And at 6'10", from the Phoenix Suns, Amari Stoudemire. Ladies and gentlemen.
NBA All-Star Weekend continues on Rogers Sportsnet. It's East versus West, and defense is optional. The game's best square off at the annual NBA All-Star Game. Coverage begins tomorrow at 7:30 Eastern, 4:30 Pacific on Rogers Sportsnet.
this the help desk?
Yes, sir.
I need help with this.
What is it?
It's my invention.
What's wrong with it?
Nothing.
So what's the problem?
Everyone's going to want one.
I see.
My company is small. This is huge.
You need to grow fast.
Exactly.
Can I see it?
Have a look.
Whoa.
Help desk.
Time to think about
taxes. Taxes on income. Taxes on investments. Taxes on my property. And my special favorite, taxes on tax. How do you deal with this, Chris?
I don't worry about it.
Well, why not?
My investors group consultant. And the plan.
The plan by Investors Group, a personalized approach to financial planning designed to help you prosper now and over time.
The championship is coming. The NCAA tournament starts March 15th on Rogers Sportsnet.
What's crack-a-lackin', y'all? Your man Miles Thirst here. Welcome to the 2005 Sprite Rising Star Slam Dunk.
NBA All-Star Saturday night is here. Magic Johnson has joined us, the Hall of Famer, the multiple MVP, a constant smile on his face. Hey, nice shot there from half court on your little segment early in this night.
I made that one, but I couldn't hit this little short one.
You look good. Great to have you with us. Let's take a look at some of the rules for the slam dunk competition. And really, the no penalties for missed dunks. And during the first round, each player must use another NBA player for at least one dunk. Things to kind of keep an eye on. And the prize money, $25,000 for first place. Second place, $15,000. Log on to NBA.com or America Online, keyword NBA.com, to vote for who you think will win the Sprite Rising Stars Slam Dunk Competition. Jarrett Smith from New Orleans, Josh Smith from Atlanta, Chris Anderson, New Orleans, Amari Stoudemire from Phoenix. Sprite is paired each dunker with lucky winners from Sprite's Right in Thirst campaign, and as well as select three youth from the community group of each player's team market. Now, Sprite will be awarding $25,000 to the fan who's matched with tonight's dunk champion and over $50,000 to all the participating community groups. So let's meet our teams. Supporting J.R. Smith is Michael Rowe, who is joined by the Second Harvest Kids Cafe of New Orleans, Louisiana. Supporting Chris Anderson is Janice Delzer, also joined by the Second Harvest Kids Cafe of New Orleans. Supporting Josh Smith is Desmond Fussell, joined by the John H. Harlan Boys and Girls Club of Atlanta. And supporting Amari Stoudemire is Jason Jekka, joined by the I.G. Holmes Boys and Girls Club of Phoenix, Arizona. Let's go to Cheryl Miller.
Thanks a lot, Kevin. I got a rare treat for you. The judges tonight competed in 1976 ABA Slam Dunk Contest, and I guarantee you no one will be second-guessing their scores tonight. Let's start it off with Call Me Mr. K, Larry Keenan, a three-time ABA All-Star. And the A-Train himself, Artis Gilmore, six-time NBA All-Star. And we've got George, the Iceman Gervin, three-time ABA All-Star and nine-time NBA All-Star. Legendary Finger Roll. Then the original Skywalker, David Thompson, four-time NBA All-Star, 1979 NBA All-Star, Game MVP, and of course, the legendary Julius Dr. J. Irvin, who started it all off in 1976 when he took flight from the free throw line and ended up at the free throw line. And I have to throw this in, 1995, walk me down the Hall of Fame carpet. Julius, if you look at the contestants tonight, three out of the four contestants are straight out of high school. Who do you like?
You know, I'm not supposed to have a favorite, but the big man, Amari Stoudemire, has been talking a lot of trash because you haven't had big guys win this thing. You know, they had a little bit of a disadvantage because it's more spectacular if a little man elevates and makes something happen. So the big man said he's coming with some. You know, I'm going to watch very carefully, and I'm going
to
be fair.
Okay, enjoy yourself. I'll send it over to you, Kevin.
All right, Cheryl, thank you very much. So let's talk about favorites, Madge. What do you want?
Oh, man, I'm going to have to go with Smith. Matter of fact, the first contestant here, right here.
We got two Smiths.
Yeah,
right.
I'm going to take the
J.R. Smith.
J.R. Smith. New Orleans.
He should be at North Carolina. That's why I'm not going to go with him.
That's right.
He was all set to go to Chapel Hill.
Yeah, so hopefully
his grades were too good to go there.
Oh! That's not bad, because what you have to do is come out, Magic, and you have to let everybody know, you know what, I'm in the building. I'm in the building.
Exactly.
J.R. Smith.
Oh!
But see, you know what? None of these guys warmed up well. They didn't take a layup.
Hey, no one tell you
they
what.
Have a layup line or a dunk line.
Listen, right. You can put him in a stove and he can't make that dunk. That's got nothing to do with being warm.
I say he get this one.
I bet you he don't. He That's a hard. He gonna change it.
Oh!
I told you
he'd get it.
Young fella, young legs.
Young legs, new moves. If he would have did it on the first time, he would have got a 10. If he did it on the first time, he would have got a 10.
He only get to replace one of them, don't he?
But once you see it, oh my goodness. Oh, but once you see it, once you, the surprise element is gone. But no one has ever done this in a dunk contest.
No.
We're off again to the races.
45 was the mark he was given by the judges.
Because, Kevin, every year they say, oh, we've seen it all. You can't do anything else.
Now,
everyone brings something different every year.
Does he get a missed dunk on one of those?
No, because he don't get a missed dunk.
So he out of it then?
No, he doesn't get a missed dunk.
No.
It's 45.
Yeah.
Because it never hit the rim and it never went through. It never hit the rim.
No, he got three chances at it.
Exactly.
You can only replace one,
right, but it has to hit the rim. So, technically, it was those two weren't attempts.
Well, we can't go all night. You know, TNT got it. Trust me, we can't go all night now.
Now, here's the other Smith. This is Josh Smith.
This is who I picked to win it.
Okay, he's starting out. You know, he's coming from the free throw line for
the
start.
Look at this.
Yeah,
he's
going to
split the crown.
Than I thought he was.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think he should have saved this one.
No, though. You got to come out, Magic.
No,
got to let the world know I'm here. Okay.
He was below the free throw line.
Yeah, but it wasn't much, though. Dr. J, you took off from the right there. You weren't on the free throw line either when you did that. So give on nine.
Julius, can you hear us over there?
Yeah, I hear
okay.
you guys.
Okay, now he was a good
man.
Foot.
I mean, he was a good foot inside the free throw line. And
they gave him a 45.
I don't know. That just looked like a breakaway layup to me.
Wait, Doc,
you're
that was
right.
That's almost where you took off
no,
on that
it ain't
time.
Doc. No,
yes,
no,
it was.
No.
It wasn't as good, but that's where he took off from.
Doc, you know how much love I got for you. The only thing you and him have in common, y'all both black. That's it.
I ain't mad at him at all. I'm just doing my job over here.
But
y'all keep
dunk,
it live.
That was outstanding. His first dunk, it was outstanding.
All right, here's Chris Anderson now.
He needs some more tattoos.
Now, you know he's a crowd favorite because he used to be with Denver Nuggets.
Birdman.
Larry Bird?
No, not that one. The only thing with him, he tries to do some things I don't think he's capable of doing in a dunk contest. He might try to take off from the three-point line. He's not capable. He's missing a couple of ice cubes in his tray. Uh-oh. This is nice. Oh, that was nice, though.
Very close.
That was nice. He just missed time to run. He missed time to run. I like that,
but
though.
But it's going to have to be something special, Kenny, because we've seen it before.
I had never seen that one, though, from half court.
Okay. It just says he just threw the pass out a little farther.
Man, y'all never threw a pass and tried to dunk it, have you? Are you kidding me?
No, we don't have to get up. I was already up there.
Oh, bad throw.
All right. It's not going to work.
Bad throw. That first one was the one. That was the one.
You know what he's done? He's picked out something on the scoreboard. That's what he's throwing at. I mean, he's been taking aim at this.
There it is.
Yep, right there.
There it is.
No bad pass.
Okay.
Too far ahead.
Yeah. See, he's practices. So you're right, Kevin. He's got it where he wants it. Now the bounce has got to be right.
See, the first one was a perfect
bounce. For nervousness. You got to account for nervousness here.
Oh, there it is. There it is. There it is.
Now, yeah,
there it
far is. Away.
It's gotta be perfect. See?
Don't even know we gotta go to commercial break?
I like that.
Hey,
though.
Charles, this is like hit till you're happy on the first tee.
Hey, how many mulligans he get? Damn.
Well, I'll tell you one.
Hey, Chris, you only get one mulligan per 18.
All right, y'all gotta edit this.
Here it is.
Here's what?
I'm gonna be tired.
Hey, we need a Snicker bar right now.
I'm gonna tell you, kid. Let's go.
Like I tell you, he sometimes does things that he might not be capable of.
He's gonna be tired, but
well, this is his seventh toss right here. Seventh.
Okay. Again, that's a bad.
Here comes number eight coming up. Yeah.
He's holding us captive.
You know what? He's practiced this so much, he doesn't have a B dunk. Right. This is his A dunk.
If he doesn't get this, he's not getting this right there.
Oh!
That's not a dunk either? That's not an attempted dunk?
No, you got to make it.
You got
to
make it.
Normally you go to your B dunk. He doesn't have one right now.
You can't miss
this
many times.
He ain't got past eight.
Well, yeah, you try till you make one. That's the rule.
Yeah.
Here he goes.
I got to give him a six just because, you did it 16 times.
No, nine.
Hey, it's at least a nine. Gave him 1 point.
Whatever,
hey,
man.
Give him 1 point for a
ten. Nah, man. I would have been mad at him for keeping me there. That was nice on the first time.
I can hear TK upstairs screaming. He messed up about three TK's commercials.
He got a 41, so Josh Smith and J.R. Smith, they have 45, and Chris Anderson at 41.
Amari Stoudemire asked, could he do a warm-up layup just to get loose again? After wait for 45 minutes.
Yeah.
He needs to do something to warm up.
No, I remember those days. You don't have to warm up when you're that age.
Okay, let me see what he's going to do. That's nice, though.
That's not bad. No, you know what? That's nice because he's going to get penalized because he's a big guy, too.
Yeah.
If a little guy did that dunk, it'd be better.
He put it between his legs, came from the side. Oh, that's like Dominique. But he just couldn't put it on his feet like Dominique used to do.
See, but to me, though, if those are nines, then J.R. Smith's was a 10.
And the standings after the first round with Smith and Stoudemire at 45 and Chris Anderson at 41. Coming up, the Dunkers get their second attempt to move on to the finals. NBA All-Stars Saturday night, presented by America Online, continues from Denver, Colorado on TNT.
This week, take a little trip to Sin City with Sportsnet News. Tonight, join Sean McCormick and get inside access to the violent world of Ultimate Fighting.
Vegas, baby, Vegas, all week long, only on Sportsnet News.
Get lost.
Yeah, go away.
Ha 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 ha.
Honey, your dad got your favorite.
He looks hungry.
New hot fresh toasted subs are here, like the chicken bacon ranch, toasted hot inside and out. Subway, eat fresh.
RBK pumps, inflatable shoes for a custom fit.
Hey, great party, man. Lots of ladies, huh? Oh, she's got hungry eyes, and I am an all-you-can-eat buffet.
Small can, strong beer. New Molson Canadian 6.0 cold shots.
Have some fun with video phones from Rogers Wireless. Record, send, play. Get two phones from $29.99 on couples plan.
The new 170 horsepower Corolla XRS.
Whoa.
Once you're into it, you're really into it. The new lightning-fast Corolla XRS. Once you're into it, you're really into it.
The Sprite Rising Stars Slam Dunk. Here is our TNT Total Motion with Josh Smith of the Atlanta Hawks, and he got a 45 from the judges on that dunk.
And that's a total waste of money, too.
Total Motion.
It's a total waste of money.
I like it. I like looking at it. No judge gave a 10 on any attempt, guys.
I bet you the same person approved that thing as the same person who approved that merger.
Or approved you going to HBO, maybe. Yeah, how about that?
Hey, listen, I'd be better on HBO.
You'll be uncensored.
I'll be uncensored.
Oh, wow.
I need to be on
Buckle
HBO.
Up.
Wait, y'all show Gilligan's Island, y'all worried about what I'm going to do?
All right, here's J.R. Smith from New Orleans, and his teammate Chris Anderson
on,
is helping.
Chris,
this is,
well, first of all, Chris
can tell
is sabotaging.
He's not no guard.
He's sabotaging.
Hey, Chris, he's trying to milk his time.
Chris, you got to bounce it up higher, dog.
Hey, Chris, trying to sabotage to get to the next round.
Oh! I like that. I like that. Yeah, young fella.
You know, but Chris killed it. He killed it.
No, Chris trying to sabotage it, man. He trying to get to the finals himself.
Oh, that was nice.
That was nice, but, you know, we seen Vince Carter.
He got a 45 out of this.
Yeah, but we seen Vince Carter catch it, put it between his legs, and kind of do that same dunk. So you got to step your game up.
But you can't judge him by Vince. Come on, man.
But I can't give you a 10.
No, well, and Julius Erving gave him a 10, didn't you, Doc?
Did you?
Yeah. You know, that was very, very difficult dunk. Timing, he had to catch it. And then he was falling away from the basket. I mean, the way he threw it back. I mean, he was out by the corner of the backboard when he threw the ball in.
Good point.
And he had Chris on there, too, so that's a handicap.
Yeah, so he had liability. No question about it. It was a liability. You know, he made something out of something less than spectacular.
All right, now, with the 45 there on his second dunk, here is Josh Smith and Kenyon Martin of the Denver Nuggets will help. They have the same agent, and they've developed this friendship. And Kenyon is trying to serve as a mentor for this kid who played in high school ball a year ago.
I was just—I thought he was just trying to say, "Yo, I'm a dunk on you during the season."
Okay, that was sweet.
Okay, now you're talking. Because not only you catch it, you pump it in the air. I'm feeling that one. Yeah.
5 tens given by the judges.
Man. That's a 10 in any dunk contest, that's a 10.
Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about.
Look at the crowd is absolutely going nuts.
That's what I'm talking
Standing
about.
Standing ovation.
You can see Magic right here. The dunk contest is where you make your name. And here it is for him. Oh, my goodness. He's making his name out here.
But did you see first the left leg and then the right? Look at
that. Yes.
Oh, my goodness.
Nice point.
Oh, my goodness.
You wonder where D. Brown was. You remember where Kenny Walker was, Skywalker. Josh Smith is going to be named. His name is going to start to become famous around here if he keeps doing dunks like that. Give me that.
Magic, for you, it sounds like the footwork, the legwork, that's kind of a big part of the style point.
Exactly. You have to give more than just a dunk. He gave body, footwork. It reminded me of Michael Jordan, Dr. J, Dominique Wilkins. They gave you everything. Vince Carter. That was everything. That was tremendous. He could have did that dunk with the greatest dunkers.
Wow. Guys, that was a
classic
case of an initiation, execution, and punctuation.
Yes.
Mr. Classy, Dr. J.
Hey, Doc, no liabilities on that one.
Chris Anderson. Smith is going to see
way, to pay, way to pay him back, Smith. Way to pay him back.
Way to get it. Way to get it. What they said about payback.
Hey, you know what? Chris Anderson's got more airtime than the show Friends. He's been on TV more than Friends.
Yes, I know it.
He's on TV more than Friends.
Hey, Doc. He don't get to play a lot. He's trying to get there, but I know he is.
I was going to check on their record down in New Orleans.
Oh, you got to catch that.
Hey, Doc.
shot. If you give him more than a 7, I'm coming over there. You can't give him more than a 7. I don't care if he jumped through the roof right now.
Remember, it took him 9.
No, there it is. If he jumps through the roof right now, you can't give him a 10.
Can you get the camera on the players on the baseline? They're just falling out. Allen Iverson, all of them are just going crazy.
6th attempt.
All right.
If you give him, there it is. Thank you.
Remember, he took 9 attempts on his first dunk. There's some 7s. So 9 wait. On his first and 6 attempts on his second.
So he has 15 dunks to get 2.
Yeah,
are you
right,
kidding
yeah,
me?
Exactly
yo,
right.
I think I could come out there and get 15 attempts to get made.
But,
nah,
hey, Kevin, you can't. Kevin, he's had his workout for the All-Star weekend. He doesn't have to work out on Monday.
Oh, my God. Yo, Bill Russell's over here cracking me up because he's laughing. He's like, he's got fingers up every time he goes, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hey, Magic.
Uh-huh.
This is hard. It's harder than it looks, but it ain't that hard. I figured, I guess Chris was like, you know what? I don't know what I'm going to do, but I'll practice on the stage here. So he was practicing his dunks.
Well, I tell you what, in fairness, he's going to be the most memorable thing tonight.
That's probably right. All right, so Amari Stoudemire.
Hey, I was watching TBS earlier. They were showing Tin Cup.
Oh! I like this. I like this.
Remember, Nash
like
grew
this.
Up playing soccer in British
like
Columbia.
This.
If he gets this,
like
it's going to be crazy.
I like this. Oh, he got it.
Oh! That was terrific.
Steve Nash is the MVP. Steve Nash for MVP.
Tell you something, the dunk contest is back. It's back.
Every time you say there's yeah, nothing new, something new. That's a perfect pass. The leader, league leader in assists, off the head, to Amari, twist turn.
Oh.
Yes, sir.
Gosh, is that fun?
Oh, my goodness.
Kevin, we've been down for about 3 years in the dunk contest, but it is back with some rising young stars.
I told you, you don't need the names, you need the game.
Wow.
You don't need names in the dunk contest, you need game.
This is turning into a Phoenix Sun weekend.
I told you. Is.
They've won the first 3 competitions. Right now, they're on top. Here, let's go to Cheryl Miller. Woo.
Hey, Kevin, for a minute there, it looked like a Smith and Smith final. That wasn't the case. Josh, why Kenyon Martin as a prop?
Because he just did something in the second dunk with Steve Nash. That was just tremendous. But I'm going to try to take it home, though.
All right, Amari, you got to talk about this. Off the backboard, off Steve Nash's head, who came up with the idea?
Well, that's something me and Steve came up with in practice and decided to come out here and do it.
All right, guys, good luck in the finals.
Man. Well, when Magic Johnson says something is back, that's a stamp of approval I think all NBA fans can hang their hat on.
Yes.
That was hot.
That was wonderful.
That was hot.
The Sprite Rising Stars Slam Dunk Competition continues from Denver Next on TNT.
Don't want a nation under the new media.
Don't miss NBA All-Star Weekend. Sportsnet News' Barry Davis covers all the events from the Rookie Sophomore Challenge to the Slam Dunk Contest and the All-Star Game itself. NBA All-Star Weekend coverage on Sportsnet News.
Here, and I'm telling the world, get your skis shined up, grab a stick of Juicy Fruit, the taste is gonna move ya, take a sniff, pull it out, the taste is gonna move ya when you pop it in your mouth, Juicy Fruit is gonna move ya, the juice is
off,
it gets right
sweet.
New Juicy Fruit Blue, sweet.
Men don't like to shave. They'd rather light their shorts on fire or eat dirt. Easy, fellas. Nivea helps soothe your skin after shaving. With moisturizers and vitamins, Nivea for Men Aftershave Balm soothes and improves the look of your skin. Nivea for Men. More evolved skincare.
Battling heartburn? Experience a whole new Tums with a unique dual-layer tablet. Tums Dual Action quickly neutralizes stomach acid, then helps keep heartburn away. New Tums Dual Action. It works fast, and it lasts.
Hey, Don, can we get your...
Just a minute, darling. Just a minute.
This Quiznos Real Deal menu?
It's great.
$3.99 every day.
It's not that. It's the taste.
$3.99.
It's the taste.
$3.99.
Taste.
$3.99.
You want to go?
Grapes? I'm a finesse player now.
Well, with those hands, you're not.
What did you say?
It was him, Ty.
Introducing the Quiznos Meatball Sandwich, one of six oven-toasted Real Deal sandwiches.
$3.99 every day.
Quiznos. Toasty.
Don't miss NBA All-Star Weekend. Sportsnet News' Barry Davis covers all the events from the Rookie Sophomore Challenge to the Slam Dunk Contest and the All-Star Game itself. NBA All-Star Weekend coverage on Sportsnet News.
Hit me!
Invented by Charles Barkley, perfected by TNT engineers. Here is TNT Total Motion.
Total waste of money, y'all.
Josh Smith of the Atlanta Hawks over Kenyon Martin.
Unbelievable.
Hey, Kenny.
Yeah.
Wouldn't you like to just see these guys go at it back and forth, dunk, five dunks apiece.
That's what's up.
That type of competition.
The old school.
Rhythm, getting the crowd in it, working them into a frenzy.
No question, because I know they have more dunk stock than the ones that they've shown.
Right. But this is MTV. Like, spike it once, get a 50, get out of here.
Exactly. You know what? If Doc, too, if Amari could have waited and used that other one.
He's bringing back the dunk. Oh. He's killing me He's killing me right now.
That's awesome right there.
Gun, whatever you do, you got my vote.
And give up the respect to Dominique all at the same time.
I give you a 10 because of respect, the hype, everything. You get a 10 just because of that.
Hey, he deserves it for giving Dominique respect.
That was off the hook.
And he got 50. Got 10s right across from the judges.
I wonder if they got a Connie Hawkins jersey over there.
Oh, man.
Yeah, that's hot.
That's Dominique, though. I always tell people, Dominique Swift is probably the most underrated player in NBA history.
You know what I love about Josh right now? Ooh, my goodness.
Ooh.
It's the fact that he's thought about this dunk contest.
Yeah.
Like, some guys come to this contest, and they can fly and jump, but they have no thought. He thought about this. He brought the jersey out. He brought Kenyon Martin out. He's bringing everybody out. He might bring Chuck out. And Chuck, you going out there next?
No, baby.
Sometimes, man, when a guy is dunking and he gets into emotion, you can see where he's going, what he's going to do, how it's going to end up. I had no idea what that guy was going to do, man.
That's true. I love it when them young pops.
Until it was done.
I love when these guys pay homage to guys like Dominique, Dr. J, guys who made the NBA what it is today.
Bringing the jersey back probably was the most memorable moment.
But it's one thing to bring the jersey back. It's another thing to get up there and dunk and fly like that. So he not only brought the jersey back, but he was unbelievable dunk. Here come Amari now.
Let's put a lot of pressure.
Yeah, this is a lot of pressure. He knows it's got to go down. He knows that.
Kenny, you're not excited, are you?
He knows that.
Okay.
Got to end on a make.
If he puts that in, though, that's a 10.
It's going to be hard for a big man.
If he puts that in, that's a 10.
That's right. It's a little bit different.
It's hard for Kenny. He can't fly like Smith can fly.
You know what? And I'm not sure he can palm the ball either.
Yes.
There's a big difference, guys, who can palm the ball.
No. He can't fly, Kenny. It's a different. He's a jumper has to be like on the move.
Easier for guys to fly and they can palm the ball though.
You see, I know there it is. I know he's practiced that dunk, but the pressure that Josh Smith put on him made him miss those two. Because see, if he would have did it the first time, he would have got 10.
Something else that you noticed, when he was trying to dunk the first time, he tried to do it with one hand. He dunked that ball with two hands. Because people used to always ask me, why do I dunk with two hands? Because my hands are too small to palm the ball. And there's a big difference being able to palm the ball, or guys who can jump off one leg or two legs. A huge difference.
He got a 45, so right now he is 5 points in back of the Atlanta Hawks.
So that's the only
Josh
thing
Smith.
He did different. He did it with two hands.
Doc, if you think he did that on the first dunk, you might have gave him a 10.
I think he would have got a better score, but, you know, the punctuation, that was missing from that dunk.
Right.
You know, style, creativity, degree of difficulty, but, you know, nailing it with punctuation, and I think the misses compromised that.
Oh! He's the winner right now. You can put your bags up. You can get your pocketbooks, ladies and gentlemen. You can get your wallets, get your jackets.
You know, we
got the winner right there.
Hey, you know, we always said the chicken dinner.
That's right.
Can you see the elevation and the hang time? See, this is what Amari can't do. He can't hang in the air.
He's a power dunker.
That's right. So he can be creative. That's the difference between Smith and Amari Stoudemire. Look at that hang time.
Elevation.
That's the difference right there.
Kenny, who's
I think we both did.
No, you're a damn liar.
Oh, yes, we did. I did.
I'm
upstairs, we said it. I came down and said it looks like a
Phoenix.
I'm going
to put you in your eye.
Okay, dude.
I'm going to punch you.
As long as it's on camera so I can see you.
Kevin and Irvin ain't going to testify against me.
I want to see you go against Vince Carter, young gun. I want to see that. I want to see LeBron in this one.
That's right.
That's what I want to see.
Vince Carter.
I want to see Vince, LeBron, and Josh Smith in here. That's what I want to see next year.
But they don't like the competition.
I see LeBron got the Yankees hat on.
I tell you who else I want to see.
Oh, I know what he's going to do. Flipping it backwards.
Back.
Oh. There it is.
Oh.
I know. That's in the video games. That's in that Xbox video game when the guy flicks it up. These guys have been watching too much. These video games are sick right now. Come on, Steve. You can do it. You got to do it with the right
leg. He'll get it.
You got it.
Yes.
But the creativity factor has been terrific
tonight.
That's
right.
I don't know who gets the more points, though, Steve or Amari for the dunk.
I don't care if he misses, make it. The dunk contest is back because guys are thinking it
there
out
it is.
Now.
Oh! Yo, but you see how high he is, though?
So, Kenny, challenge those guys again. Call those names out again,
Kenny. Smith is there waiting for you, Vince Carter. Josh Smith is waiting for you, LeBron James. Josh Smith is waiting for you, Kobe. Come in for 1 year, shut it all down, and silence all the critics.
That's right. There it is right there. Kenny, say it. It's what?
Silence the critics. Come on, we're waiting on you. We're waiting on you. Because I'm going to hype it up.
That's right. See, Kevin, he can't hang. See, that's the difference. If that was Smith, he would have caught that and dunked it.
He would have caught that.
Pretty simple, but
yeah, it started out difficult, but yeah, the simplicity came. But you got to give him a 9 or 8. Yeah, I agree with that.
You got to give him second place, too.
Yeah, I agree with that, too.
But it's been a Phoenix Sun night, no matter what. Unbelievable. They represented very well. And look out for that team in the playoffs, too. People, if you want to see an exciting team, you watch the Phoenix Suns play.
Because Saturday night is what they call a skills night. And Phoenix Suns got a lot of skills on their team.
Yeah.
That's hot right there. Look at that.
Yeah.
You know, Steve used to ice skate, too. They might be ice skating next year. He used to be a hockey player. They might bring out the ice skates next year.
And let me say thank you to Atlanta Hawks for bringing Dominique back into the organization, giving him a meaningful job as well.
It's about time.
19-year-old Josh Smith is the Sprite Rising Stars Slam Dunk Champion. Let's go to Cheryl Miller.
Josh, first and foremost, congratulations. Forget that you had big shoes to fill right next to you. You put on Dominique's jersey. How much of an influence, obviously, has he had in your life?
He's been a big influence ever since I played for the Hawks. He's took me under his wing and taught me some stuff and how to get by in workouts and in the game.
Now, Dominique, you won this competition twice. How much old school did this young fella have in him?
Well, you're talking about filling shoes. I think he have his own shoes now. I knew coming into this contest that he would do great. You know, I've seen him all year, and I knew the things that he could do. He kind of surprised me today, though.
Okay, Josh tonight, out of all the dunks, was Kenyon Martin your favorite?
Yeah, I mean, we worked on this as soon as I got here. He plays with Denver, so it's kind of hard to work on it with him. So Thursday when I came here, we went to the gym and worked on it.
Hey, smile a little bit. You're the champion, all right? Slam Dunk 2005. Josh Smith, ladies and gentlemen, congratulations.
He grew up in Atlanta, idolizing Dominique Wilkins, and that was his inspiration tonight. He is the 2005 All-Star Slam Dunk Champion.
The championship is coming. The NCAA tournament starts March 15th on Rogers Sportsnet.
Get lost!
Yeah, go away!
Ha 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 ha!
Honey, your dad got your favorite.
He looks hungry.
New hot fresh toasted subs are here, like the chicken bacon ranch, toasted hot inside and out. Subway, eat fresh.
The Pump by Reebok, available at Foot Locker.
Is this the help desk?
Yes, sir.
I need help with this.
What is it?
It's my invention.
What's wrong with it?
Nothing.
So what's the problem?
Everyone's going to want one.
I see.
My company's small. This is huge.
You need to grow fast.
Exactly.
Can I see it?
Have a look.
Whoa.
Help desk.
Introducing new Dentine Tango. Intense berry flavor, so juicy and so tempting. You've never done a tango like this before. New Dentine Tango. Taste the forbidden fruit.
Upon further review, the goal has been disallowed. No goal. No goal.
Have some fun with video phones from Rogers Wireless. Record, send, play. Starting from $29.99. Men don't like to shave. They'd rather light their shorts on fire or eat dirt. Easy, fellas. Nivea helps soothe your skin after shaving. With moisturizers and vitamins, Nivea for Men Aftershave Balm soothes and improves the look of your skin. Nivea for Men. More evolved skincare.
Nobody stands behind their cars like Mitsubishi. Because every new Mitsubishi now comes with a 10-year powertrain limited warranty, 5-year new vehicle limited warranty, and 5-year roadside assistance. Mitsubishi, the best bad cars in the world. He came back, came on my chance.
Moments ago, Donald B. King, Group Brand Director, Sprite, presented the Sprite Rising Stars Slam Dunk Champion Trophy to Josh Smith, who is accompanied by his Sprite contest winner, Desmond Fussell, in the John H. Harlan Boys and Girls Club of Atlanta. Sprite will be awarding $25,000 to Desmond and over $50,000 to all participating community groups. Now our NBA.com results on the slam dunk. And most of you thought that Amari Stoudemire would get it. And Josh Smith in that voting of over 61,000 picked Josh Smith number two. A night where the Phoenix Suns took three of the four events, but it was a teenager from Atlanta who stole the show. And on All-Star Saturday Night post-game show from Denver, Colorado continues on TNT.
NBA All-Star Weekend on Rogers Sportsnet. Brought to you by Reebok, by Gatorade, and by Molson Canadian.
At Foot Locker.
Hey, great party, man. Lots of ladies, huh? Oh, she's got hungry eyes, and I am an all-you-can-eat buffet.
Small can, strong beer. New Molson Canadian 6.0 cold shots.
New Tylenol Cold with Cool Burst, demo number 6. How fast will he feel the cool burst sensation? Oh. Oh my. New Tylenol Cold with Cool Burst coating. A cool, soothing sensation you can feel instantly.
Speed Stick 24/7 gives you proven non-stop protection. Time-release sweat and odor fighters, SpeedStick's always there when you need it the most. For as long as you need it. SpeedStick 24/7. It never quits.
Men don't like to shave. They'd rather light their shorts on fire or eat dirt. Easy, fellas. Nivea helps soothe your skin after shaving. With moisturizers and vitamins, Nivea for Men Aftershave Bomb soothes and improves the look of your skin. Nivea for Men. More evolved skincare.
Get lost!
Yeah, go away! Ha 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 ha
ha! Honey, your dad got your favorite.
He looks hungry.
New hot fresh toasted subs are here, like the Chicken Bacon Ranch, toasted hot inside and out. Subway, eat fresh.
Now you and your buddies can score big. Visit pokeroom.com for non-stop hold'em every Saturday night, and you can win a hockey dream trip to Sweden. Get in the game at pokeroom.com. meet them and beat them.
Welcome back to Denver. You've been watching NBA All-Star Saturday Night. This is our post-game show, and all presented by America Online. And this is the guy that was as captivating as any single performance tonight, 19-year-old Josh Smith, the rookie with the Atlanta Hawks. We're just having an interesting conversation with Kenny, the Jet, Sir Charles, and Magic about this kid, and even stretching back into Dominic Wilkins, who this kid put his jersey on right there. It was a very poignant moment tonight.
Yeah, well, I think so. I think one of the things, Dominique has gotten a lot of notoriety in his life and his career, but that had to make him feel good because he paid homage to a guy who really made this contest popular.
Yeah, but also, I think the Hawks have done Dominique a disservice And Dominique's been the most underrated player of my generation. I think all the guys who were great players got their honors except Dominique Wilkins. I'm looking forward to him going into the Hall of Fame. I want to thank the Hawks organization for bringing him back in, because he's never gotten the credit or respect he's deserved.
And then Kevin, Quentin Richardson bought the three-point shooting contest back. Then Josh Smith bought the slam dunk back.
Right.
All-Star Weekend is back. If they come out tomorrow and play that game hard and competitive, All-Star Weekend is back at its highest level. Because tonight, the slam dunk proved that we're back. We're back in a big way. Oh, Josh Smith, thank you, baby. It's back.
It began with the Jordans and the Wilkins and people like that competing. But over the last couple of years, some of the bigger names have shunned this
event.
That's
right.
Yeah, and I always say you don't need your name. You need your game in a dunk contest, because guys come here to put on a show. And sometimes the name guys feel like they don't need any more recognition. So I'm happy for guys like, remember, D. Browns and Kenny Walkers and Spud Webbs and now Josh Smiths. Now weren't household names, but you know them now.
Yeah, but the problem I have with that, we got to argue about this on the show the other night. If Dominique Wilkins, Dr. J,
that's
Michael
right.
Jordan, if those guys could get in the slam dunk, some of these guys in the NBA who are stars, why can't they do it?
Oh, they can.
Yeah.
They should.
Yeah.
Well, they're not.
Right.
But that's wrong.
But also, too, to everybody's point, every day it sets the tone for the next day. The rookie game set the tone for tonight. Tonight it went to a high level, and then this sets the tone for tomorrow. Kenny, call out those names for the slam dunk contest.
I'm going to say it like
year.
This, because if LeBron James, you're in it, and then Kobe Bryant, you're in it, and Vince Carter, you're in it, and then John Smith wins, now it's off the hook. Now it means something, because Spud, the reason he was really famous, because he beat Dominique.
That's right, that's right.
Don't forget Jason Richardson.
Right,
either.
Jason Richardson.
Yeah,
throw it off the glass and come get it again.
That's right.
No
that's
question.
Right. But it was great. I'm excited. Man, I can't wait till tomorrow, because we have so many talented open court players tomorrow. That's what makes the All-Star game great. And so both sides, East and West, got great open court players, and this set the tone for tomorrow. I can't wait for tomorrow.
They said, that's how I get better looking every day. I can't wait for tomorrow.
We want to take one more look at the Amari Stoudemire, Steve Nash dunk with a little bit of a soccer work there by Nash.
Yeah, off the glass, off the head. If he could have saved this to the finals,
yes.
He might have shut it down in the finals with this.
That's true. Yeah, timing is sometimes everything when these things are exposed.
And also, Kevin, entertainment is back into the NBA game. See, that's entertainment.
Yeah.
And you know what? You always say, I said it twice earlier, that NBA players are running out of dunks. These are the most creative, athletic players in the world.
Yes.
They're going to come up with something you haven't seen. You can have it for next 10 years, and 10 years from now, there'll be a dunk that hasn't been done before.
There's no hockey right now, unfortunately. Football is over. We don't do steroids. We're the best athletes. We're the best athletes in the world.
Josh Smith is not the youngest to win. Kobe was younger than Josh Smith.
I'm not sure Kobe won't any of that right now.
Yes,
I'm not sure Kobe won't.
It'd be
that
fun
look.
To watch, though.
I'm not sure either.
I'd pay to watch it.
Yes, this kid got hang time and creativity.
Right.
Kevin told me he'll pay to watch it. Okay, he's seen some of these ticket prices.
But it was just fun. I think that, and let's give Phoenix Suns organization a pat on the back for representing
Phoenix.
Suns.
Yeah, he said it.
Organization to represent so well.
Oh, yeah, right.
Yeah,
and I'm big in Phoenix.
Yeah, because they did a nice job.
Big everywhere.
Big everywhere.
Did a nice job.
We'll come back and wrap up NBA All-Stars Saturday night next on TNT.
Good thing I'm not sensitive.
There's so much we can do now. We can add new appliances.
Our family can finally have new floors.
At the Home Depot, you can. We're lowering prices every day in every department. And right now, use your Home Depot consumer credit card and take advantage of no payments, no interest for 12 months on everything in flooring, kitchen, bath, and decor. You can afford to do it now.
At the Home Depot, you can do it. We can help.
Hey! Who shipped the 200 boxes to our client in Boston? Was it you, Lewis?
I shipped them with FedEx. You're a heck of a man doing a heck of a job, Lewis.
Trust the company with proven reliability. Relax, it's FedEx.
The NBA on Rogers Sportsnet HD, featuring superior picture that's 5 times the resolution of an ordinary TV and a widescreen format that features more of the action. Catch the Celtics and Lakers in high definition, Tuesday at 10:30 Eastern, 7:30 Pacific on Rogers Sportsnet HD.
Our wrap-up continues on the NBA All-Star Saturday Night Post-Game Show presented by AOL. It was a night that the Phoenix Suns began 3-of-3 in the Shooting Stars. They won that with Dan Marley and Sean Marion and Diana Taurasi. Then the PlayStation Skills Challenge captured by Steve Nash in 25.8 seconds. Foot Locker three-point shootout. Quentin Richardson hit his final 9 shots. And then to break the Phoenix Suns ride, it was a 19-year-old player from the Atlanta Hawks, Josh Smith, with a spectacular series of dunks that captured the imagination of all the judges here.
What a bum Amari Stoudemire is. They shouldn't let him go back on the charter.
Well, let me tell you what Josh Smith just did. He made Jermaine Dupri, he made Ludacris and Nelly go crazy over here watching him because they were so proud of him. Jermaine Dupri has been a season ticket holder of Atlanta Hawks for a long time, and that made him feel just as proud as Dominique tonight.
Guys, great night. Thank you so much. What
Thank
a pleasure.
You, Kevin.
Good to be here.
Tomorrow, 8 o'clock Eastern time, tune into TNT for exclusive coverage of the 2005 NBA All-Star Game featuring special musical acts Destiny's Child, Leanne Rimes, and country duo Big and Rich. Next, it's Life with Eddie Murphy and Martin Lawrence. For our entire TNT crew, Kevin Harlan saying goodnight from NBA All-Stars Saturday night in Denver, Colorado.
Nation of players whose abilities will merge to create a dynamic structure. The East, cold, strong, and determined, where the game evolved on the streets in the shadows of its architecture.
Iverson goes creeping out of bounds.
The West, warm, wild, and full of style, where the structural design feeds its creativity.
Oh, what a move by Yao Ming! Kevin Garnett is taking over this game. Tim Duncan again. And all